cap.
Jalen Catalan is the man. This guy flies around. He makes plays. He had two interceptions. He's all over the place. Not only that, but Arkansas uses him. Barry Odom's coaching system puts him in definitely in the best position ever. He roams the middle of the field. He's playing zone. He's playing man. He's stopping the run. He's stopping the pass. I love watching this young man play.
Hey, this is Darren McFadden. You're listening to The Morning Rush.
Live from the Busch Light Studios. Bush.
People who really want to have a good time won't come to a slaughterhouse. And we've got entirely too many troublemakers here.
On your favorite Arkansas sports talk station.
I don't like you because you're dangerous.
That's right. I am dangerous.
Streaming live from
hitthatline.com.
I hit the 7-iron like John Davis the 3.
This is The Morning Rush with Ty Richardson.
You just got to keep living, man.
And Tommy Kraft.
We follow orders or people die. Are we clear?
The Morning Rush starts right now.
Yes, sir.
Live from the Branson Landing on a football Friday, getting ready for the Powerboat National Grand Prix alongside Tommy Kraft. I'm Ty Richardson. We are one day out from Arkansas and Texas. We had a great matchup of football last night between the Dallas Cowboys and the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. Kind of surprised in how that outcome ended. Give the Dallas Cowboys credit. They hung in there, but ultimately, as he often does, Tom Brady comes out the victor. Clay Henry is going to join us at 7 o'clock this morning. Coach Houston Nutt is kind enough to join us at 8 o'clock, and we've got a loaded show for you all morning long.
Man, what a weekend we have coming up. I'm jacked up about just everything going on. We're going to tell you what's going to be happening in Branson, so there's plenty of time if you're not going to the game to come enjoy what we're going to be telling you about with the Powerboat Nationals. I know a lot of folks in the natural state are focused on the Horns being in town, and what an experience we hope it is in the stadium with the atmosphere and the crowd. And, you know, Ty, just really for the first time, and I know you got a taste of it last week, everybody kind of gathering together for Razorback football in a full house. It's just going to be a fun, special weekend. We're going to remember 9/11 this weekend for the 20th remembrance of that. So, big week. It's Hogs versus Horns all week long here on The Morning Rush in ESPN Arkansas, presented by Crane Hyundai of Fayetteville. Find them at cranehyundaiofayetteville.com or on West Foxglove Drive in Fayetteville. And by Arvest Bank, they provide a wide range of banking services, including loans, deposits, treasury management, credit cards, mortgage loans, and mortgage services. Visit them at arvest.com. Equal housing lender, member FDIC.
Got some good Italian food in me last night. I slept like a baby, whether it was the comfortable hotel bed here at the Hilton or the food that I was plentifully stuffed with last night. I slept good and had some good football on last night. As I mentioned, we watched the first half of the Cowboys and Buccaneers, and we were talking to Jim before we came on, one of our associates here at ESPN 104.3, the fact that we were all kind of surprised the outcome that Dallas was able to stay within, especially with Tom terrific clicking in the first half, and then he just – and give Dak Prescott credit, his first game back after the injury, not just last year, but the injuries he suffered with the shoulder and all the offseason that he's had to go through this year, was a terrific football game.
Yeah, 31-29, if you haven't looked at your phone yet to check out the score. When I fell asleep, it was 21-19. Dallas had just kicked the field goal, and I really thought, you know, like Tampa Bay playing at home and Tom terrific and all these things you just talked. He had four touchdowns in the game. I thought, you know, they'd probably win by clear 10 or more in this game. But you know, Dallas hung in there. I mean, it's a loss. I mean, I'm sure some fans feel like they have a lot more to be optimistic about after last night, but because Tampa Bay is going to be one of the favorites again to be in the Super Bowl.
And the game that we're all looking forward to is JT and Hot Springs remind us it is 36 hours till game time. If you got a chance to see some of the videos last night on Dixon Street, it was lively. I saw a video of Texas fans walking in to a bar, and they were greeted rudely and loudly, as they should be every single time they step foot in an establishment in Northwest or any part of Arkansas. And this is a game that I think Texas fans have started to realize how much it means to us, and I think they're going to get a little more invested in this game than potentially outside of Oklahoma, any game they have on their schedule this year.
Well, and because there's not a lot of Big 12 games, you know, that you got. You know, Kansas State's not probably going to rile the fan base up. You know, Iowa State might be one.
It's going to be a heck of a game.
Oklahoma State's still a traditional, you know, notch on your schedule. But yeah, I think for a large part of, you know, of our audience, we've talked about what this game means, because if you're under probably age of 40, you don't have a lot of history with this series. You just know that you played them in some bowl games and a couple of regular season games along the way in the last 20 years or so. I imagine for Texas fans, they've had to also do some reading up, unless you're, you know, 45, 50 or older, because it's just, it's not a game you've grown up on unless you're of a certain age. So we think if it's only a here thing, you know, Texas doesn't take this series as seriously, but their fan base is, I think, probably, you're right, they're starting to get a little educated on what's going on here this week.
Yeah, and I'm curious to see. We know that the game is sold out at this point. I'm curious to see how many Texas fans are in attendance for this football game, or have made their way at least to Northwest Arkansas and to Fayetteville, because we know the Arkansas fans are going to pack it out. But there's not just a massive contingency of Longhorn fans. But I know one personally who he is the personal trainer at the gym I work at. There's my cousin who goes to Texas, and she and her friends are coming up. So I'm ultimately also curious to see how much burnt orange we see inside of Donald W. Reynolds' perspective. And listen, I want to say this right now off the bat. I hate Texas as much as every single one of you, but don't get into an altercation this weekend. Verbal assaults are fine, but we've seen too many fan videos, both professionally and collegiately, as of late. There's bottles being thrown. There's different fist fights between 40 years of age difference. We don't need that inside of Reynolds Razorback Stadium on Saturday night. As funny as it would be to see a Texas fan get trampled, ultimately it's not a good look for Arkansas. So just, I would discourage any of
what
that.
What would be funny about it?
A Texas fan getting trampled?
Yeah.
It's because it's a Texas fan, Tommy. Do I have to say any more?
Well, it's a human being, Tommy.
But it's a Texas fan, Tommy.
I mean, it's a soul in there.
If you want to take that side, that's fine. But I'm discouraging any violence of that nature. Please don't do that. That's just a bad idea. I don't want
I'm glad we got to give a disclaimer for discouraging violence.
Trying to be a good person here early, or at least at 6:07 here.
Yeah, we'll see how it goes as the sun comes up here in a little bit. But hey, if you're in the Branson, Missouri area, if you're traveling this way, maybe listening online, listening on our great station, ESPN 104.3. We're at the Hilton Convention Center in downtown Branson. This is the one across the railroad tracks from the landing. We're on the second floor near the Level 2 Steakhouse, overlooking the landing this morning, if you want to come by and say hello. Down on the landing tomorrow in Taneycomo, they're going to have the Powerboat National Races. We're going to be telling you more about that. There's plenty of time to still enjoy this event if you're not going to the game and watch the races. There's some stuff that begins actually this morning with a parade of trucks presented by American Force Wheels, and they've got things commemorating 9/11 also going on. We're going to talk to some of the folks involved throughout the morning, but a big event. If you like speedboat racing, this is going to be the place right here in Branson. We'll be telling you more as we move through the morning. Hey, if you're going to be out tonight or later today and you want to try a great chicken sandwich, stop by and see our friends at Buffalo Wild Wings. They've got the all-new classic chicken sandwich for just $5.99. You can try that this weekend. Hand-breaded chicken with pickles, mayo, and a side of fries, just $5.99 for a limited time. And good things happen after dark. After 9 p.m., half off, ultimate nachos, chips and salsa, crispy buffalo chicken tots, and more. It's all at Buffalo Wild Wings, Fort Smith, Conway, Little Rock, Sherwood, and in Jonesboro.
We've already confirmed our meeting destination tonight. I'm going to get back to Northwest Arkansas or Fort Smith probably around 12 or 1:30 today. Got a few other things to do at the station. Going to go home, take a nap, and then we're going to meet there after 9 at some point tonight because we're getting ready for Hogs versus Horns. And I know a lot of you have opinions on this. You've been talking to Phil, Drew, and Maddie. You've been talking to Derek and Zach. And now you can talk to us all throughout the morning at 877-377-6963.
Yeah, and this can be a good hour to get your score predictions in, your thoughts on the game. We've had a week to marinate in it, so text us or call us here this morning, and let's talk Hogs and Horns. This is the one we've been waiting on, not just all season, all off season long, but really for several years now, knowing this was coming on the schedule. Ty, it's finally here.
It is finally here, and again, we'll have Arkansas game day for you tomorrow. We're going to do a three-hour edition starting at 12, and then Hog Reaction will follow that game. Your calls, your texts coming up. What do you think about this game tomorrow night in Donald W.?
It's Beat Texas Week, brought to you by Crane Hyundai of Fayetteville. Visit them at CraneHyundaiofFayetteville.com or at 1919 West Fox Glove Drive today. And our best bank, ready to help you. Equal Housing Lender, member FDIC.
And he could go. The 15, the 10, the 5. Touchdown, Cedric Cobb.
When it comes to baling, the denser, the better. Williams Tractor in Fayetteville, Berryville, and Bobcat in Northwest Arkansas can show you how roll belt round balers produce denser and higher quality round bales that drive down your production costs while driving up the nutrition of your bales. A competitive comparison showed New Holland roll belt round balers provide savings in net wrap, transportation, and lower storage losses. It's like being able to afford a new baler every other year. Stop by Williams Tractor in Fayetteville, Berryville, and Bobcat in Northwest Arkansas soon to learn firsthand about the benefits of roll belt round balers.
Standard Materials Group has immediate openings for ready-mix drivers in the Northwest Arkansas area. If you have a CDL license without an automatic restriction and want to be home every night, want to work with a company that offers great pay, benefits, and a great team environment with growth opportunities, apply today at jobs.crh.com. Again, that's jobs.crh.com. Standard Materials Group is an equal opportunity employer.
Did you know that you can get your car serviced or repaired without ever leaving your house? All you have to do is call Jody's Auto Service Center at 479-649-3399. Jody's will pick up your vehicle, service or repair it for you, and return it fully disinfected to your driveway. Pickup and delivery is free for jobs $75 or more. Jobs less than $75 can be picked up and returned for a $10 fee. Let Jody's Auto Service Centers handle all your service and vehicle repair needs. Call 479-649-3399. Jody's Auto Service Center.
Summer is ending, but now is the time to start planning your backyard fun for 2022. Hi, Tommy Kraft here from my good friends at Burton Pools and Spas in Springdale and in Fort Smith. Start planning the backyard of your dreams for next summer at Burton Pools and Spas, but save right now on above-ground Doughboy pools with up to $3,500 in savings. The time is right now to stop in at Burton Pools and Spas and plan that backyard of your dreams. And again, save on Doughboy above-ground pools up to $3,500 off right now. Burton Pools and Spas in Fort Smith are at 6121 Zero Street, and find them in Northwest Arkansas just off I-49 at the 412 exit on South 48. Burton Pools and Spas has been around for more than 40 years, and they can help you design and construct the backyard of your dream. Stop in and see them in Springdale and in Fort Smith, and always online at burtonpools.com. Burton Pools and Spas, they are your source for backyard fun.
Do you remember the joy you felt as a kid about pizza night? Remember how good it smelled? You could taste it even before you opened the box. And then, that first bite. It was so good. Be the supper time savior. Order Jim's Razorback Pizza now. 434-3456. The best pizza in Fort Smith, or it's free. Jim's Razorback
Pizza! Wheels RV in Springdale wants you to seek out all the natural state has to offer this year. Explore Arkansas in a new RV from Grand Design, Forest River, KZ, Heartland, Keystone, or Alliance. All the best brands at the best prices. Enjoy peace of mind with our lifetime warranty on every new RV and a mobile service shuttle to keep you camping. So come on in and discover why Wheels RV was voted the best RV dealership in Northwest Arkansas. 5 miles west of I-49, exit 72. Seek, explore, discover with Wheels RV.
Was your roof damaged by recent storms? Don't fall victim to out-of-town contractors and fly-by-night repairmen. Trust the local roofing professionals at Able Roofing. Call their local number, 474-0006, for a free roof inspection. Never trust something as important as the roofing system on your home to a storm chaser. Able Roofing, 474-0006, will work with your insurance company. Call now for your free roof inspection, 474-0006. Able Roofing, the hometown roofers.
September is here, and at Frank Rowe Furniture, it's time to sell, sell, sell. Everything's on sale. Made in the USA furniture, family-owned, and serviced after the sale. Also, we have in-store, no-credit check financing. I want you to remember one name, Frank Rowe Furniture. Located at 405 Fort Street in Barling, Arkansas, or check us out on Facebook. Frank Rowe Furniture, best seats in the house.
ESPN 95.3.
The Morning Rush with Ty Richardson and Tommy Craft.
Allen, pump fake.
Call or text The Morning Rush at 877-377-6963.
If we lose tonight, this will be the last call you hear on this program. I'll probably be dead. Now, if I live through it, I'll call back.
Talking about the crowd atmosphere inside of Donald W. Reynolds Razorback Stadium on Saturday night. Sold out. Standing room only is being sold. You can find some tickets on some secondary and third-party sites. What is that going to mean in terms of points for Razorback football? We'll answer that coming up here on the Morning Rush.
Hey, our friends at the Arkansas Department of Health remind you to find a vaccine location near you if you have not yet gotten your COVID-19 vaccine. We see the numbers in Arkansas continue to go up when it comes to vaccines. As those numbers go up, we're seeing active cases in our state continue to drop. You know, just a few weeks ago, we were over 25,000 active cases in the state. Now, as the vaccine numbers continue to climb, that active case number is now below 20,000. So the numbers are moving in the right direction on both accounts. So if you haven't gotten your vaccine, you've made the decision to do it, find a pharmacy near you that you're comfortable with, talk to your doctor, get that, or you can find locations all over the state at healthy.arkansas.gov. That's healthy.arkansas.gov, or call 1-800-985-6030. We've been telling you, we're live in Branson this morning at the Hilton Convention Center, telling you about the events going on this weekend, Hogs and Horns. It's a packed day here and a packed weekend in our listing area. Jared Rumsberg joins us now. He handles the TV duties for the Powerboat Nationals. Good to see you. Glad to have you in our area.
Well, good morning, guys. It's great to be in Branson. And before we get things going, I'm part of the We Are Nation as a Penn State grad. Let me see if I got this right. Woo Pig Suey.
You got
Did
it.
Did I get it right?
You got
All
it.
All right. So, good deal. We're off on the right foot.
Yeah, so a big win for them over Wisconsin last week. But, hey, go be a fun weekend. I know a lot of our listeners are familiar with the Branson Landing. We're looking out here from the Hilton overlooking the Branson Landing. The Powerboat Nationals are going to be in Tanny Como. Tell us what fans could come out and see, listeners could come out and enjoy, and still have time to watch that Arkansas-Texas game.
Oh, well, I got to tell you, man, it is something that you have never seen. I mean, these, they look like fighter jets on the water, first of all, and it's one of the great things about them. And then when these engines light up, and we're in kind of a canyon cavern kind of thing here with Lake Tanny Como, the way that sound echoes and bounces around down here, I mean, it just draws everybody to the shore of Lake Tanny Como. But we'll have two classes of racing this weekend. The Pro Tunnel 2s and the Pro Tunnel 1s will be racing, and they're racing for the series championship. There's a lot of hardware going to be handed out, a lot of prestige with winning here in Branson, and it's going to be a huge crowd. And the best part about it, it costs you nothing. It's a free event. You can come on down. Costs you nothing but your time. So you come down and enjoy this and then get back in time for the Razorback.
So I know a lot of people are familiar with the landing, like we were saying, where Cantina Laredo is and the fountains and all the kind of the center of the land. You can watch for free from right there.
That's right. It's great. And we set our cameras up right by the fountains. And I say it's like being backstage at a Motley Crue concert when those things go off. Man, it is a crazy show with all the fountains and the pyros going off. And it's all right there. It's you can bring your lawn chair, you can stand there and watch, and then hop back up and grab a bite to eat, something to drink, or do some shopping at Branson Landing. And it's just a great event all day. And the weather's supposed to be absolutely perfect for, you know, low winds, high temps, and lots of sunshine, cloudless days. It's going
to
be great.
All right. Well, we're looking forward to it. We got some other folks involved with this. I think some of the maybe the racers themselves coming by later in the show to talk. I know there's some things going on today. Tell us where you do the TV side of it. Some of it's streaming, some of it's on actual TV you can find on your satellite or your cable. Tell us where they can find this event if they're not going to make it.
Sure. Our show is Racer H2O. You can find out more information at racerh2o.com. All of our racing is available online for free on our YouTube channel. Just click on the link at racerh2o.com or search Racer H2O on YouTube. You can like us on Facebook. We have a lot of bonus content there from all of our racing. We raced here in 2019, if you want to check that racing out. We also have all three races from earlier this year available on demand online. And then on your television, for those of you in Louisiana and Arkansas and in Texas, our friends in Texas, you can see us on AT&T Sportsnet Southwest. So check your local listings there. Some of you might even be able to watch us on Bally Sports Southeast, depending on how far east you are in Louisiana. So, yeah.
Well, thanks for dropping by, and we look forward to everything going on this weekend.
Guys, thank you very much. All thanks right. for the time.
Jared with us this morning talking about the Powerboat Nationals, and we'll continue to tell you about that as we are live here in Branson getting ready for Hogs and Horns this weekend. Certainly going to be a big weekend. I know that a lot of people anticipated. Ty, you and I are going to be back along at noon tomorrow from Randall Ford, 3 hours tomorrow. So if you're getting ready for the game tomorrow, we're going to be on between noon and 3. And then Phil and Rick and the whole crew is going to be along the way with Gino and Chuck and Quinn, everybody at 3 o'clock tomorrow. I'll walk you right up to 6 o'clock for game time. And then after the game, Hog Reaction. We'll be on with Ruskin and Zach. They'll be coming on after the game, probably around 11 or so, taking your calls and your reactions to the game as well. So we'll have all of that for you. Full broadcast day beginning at noon, probably stretching into the early hours of Sunday morning right here on ESPN Arkansas.
Really excited about it. I've been excited for this for quite some time. I mean, this is a game that my grandpa looked forward to every single season. I know he's watching down above on Donald W. Reynolds Razorback Stadium. The crowd was lively again on Dixon Street last night. It's going to be like that all week. We've been talking about people getting there. We were up in Northwest Arkansas yesterday talking to fans, and they were discussing about what time they were going to tailgate. I know some Morning Rush listeners are taking off work all day Friday to get set up for Saturday. I mean, this is something that everyone is looking forward to. And what Arkansas can do for the team on Saturday night is give them an advantage that we know Donald W. Reynolds Razorback Stadium has. Now, I don't know how many points Arkansas is worth, but I do know as Texas finds themselves as about a 6.5, 7-point favorite. If that was in Austin or if that was on a neutral side, it'd be much higher. But I think part of the reason that point spread is less than a touchdown is because they know Vegas knows the home atmosphere that you can provide tomorrow night. And I want to see what KJ Jefferson, nerves were a part of his past game. That's why he played poorly. It wasn't just that, but it wasn't just him too. You had Treylon Burks playing probably the worst game we've seen him in a Razorback uniform. The offense looked out of sync, but it all comes back to being on his shoulders. Can he at this, it's hard to balance this. We heard from Bill Montgomery earlier this week, the hype and the composure. You have to somehow find that middle ground as a Razorback quarterback to navigate through the waters that you're going to find yourself tomorrow night.
Yeah, and you can't get too hyped because the crowd's jacked up. You can't lose focus on what's going on out there. And particularly as we've seen, you got two linebackers that have already missed time, and we know Bumper Pool's going to be out. You can't get so hyped up that you do something that's going to be detrimental to the team for the rest of that game and perhaps next week as Arkansas is living through in this first half.
Yeah, they have to keep – it's a really, again, a fine line between getting really pumped up, really jazzed up and excited, and then not over-jumping. It's a hard balance. It's like it's not white and black. It's somewhere in between.
Yeah, everybody's got to find their comfort zone there. So a lot more coming up. Clay Henry's going to join us here. He is with us here in Branson, so we'll get his thoughts on the game coming up as well. Hey, if you're looking for more than just a job, you can check out the opportunities right now at Baxter Regional Medical Center and become an EMT or a paramedic. If you have the passion to help others and want the opportunity to work with an involved team and learn more from the best, here's your chance. Be an EMT in one semester or a paramedic in just 3 to 4 semesters and have a complete certification or degree without any student loan debt. So if you're looking for more than just a job, Baxter Regional Medical Center has your opportunity right now. Call 870-508-1883. That's 508-1883 or log on to baxterregional.org.
All right, coming up here on the Morning Rush, we still have a lot to discuss. I want to talk a little bit more about this Bucks and Cowboys matchup last night. Also, we got some Pro Hogs kicking off this weekend in the National Football League. That's all coming up on the Morning Rush. Matt, if you want to go and hit this, we'll come back after this.
Alexa, play ESPN Arkansas.
ESPN Arkansas from TuneIn.
This is former Arkansas quarterback Casey Dick, and you're listening to The Morning Rush.
The Powerball jackpot from the Arkansas Scholarship Lottery is now more than $400 million. So, what would you do if you won?
I'd buy a baseball team.
Ooh, I would definitely buy my mom a Tesla so that she can drive cool, look cool.
If I won a jackpot, I'll start a cooking school for the youth in the city.
Got your ticket? If not, visit your local lottery retailer for your chance to win the Powerball jackpot of more than $400 million. This is winning. Call 1-800-522-4700 for Problem Gambling Helpline.
Finding the places in life that give you joy is what Toyota is all about. Is your idea of fun filled with adventures? Like mountain biking with your good buddies?
Woo-hoo!
Toyota has SUVs like RAV4 and Highlander, ready to take you wherever that next adventure lies. Or maybe one of our sporty, stylish sedans, like a Camry or Corolla, to get you anywhere in style.
And we're here.
Oh, I love the theater.
Try to not fall asleep this time.
What? Me?
Or maybe your happy place is in the great outdoors, and Toyota trucks can take you camping, fishing,
got one,
or whatever you love doing. Dependable Tundra and Tacoma are built to get you to the middle of nowhere and back.
Throw another log on there.
That's providing you want to come back. So no matter where you find your joy, Toyota has vehicles ready to take you there. Get $500 customer cash, or qualified lessees can lease a new 2021 Highlander L for only $289 a month for 36 months with $29.99 due at signing. Toyota, let's go places. Visit toyota.com for details. Offers available in select states and 10-4-21.
What do you get when you pull into Tony's Tire Service? You get the best selection of tires for any car, truck, or commercial vehicle. Tony's Tire Service has Cooper tires and is ready to serve you to get you back on the road safely. They'll also get your vehicle fixed with brake replacements, plus an alignment with the best repair guy in the area. Tony's Tire Service has been serving the River Valley for over 34 years. Come let our guys replace your tires with Cooper tires and our service department to make sure the vehicle has the best brakes and alignments. Tony's Tire Service, 7200 South 28th Street in Fort Smith. Service you can depend on.
Are your real estate investments being properly managed? Are you sending a check or cashing a check each month? If you're tired of your current property managers, then call Trinity Multifamily. Trinity will qualify your tenants and leases, inspect your properties, and take care of maintenance and provide you with web-based access to current financial reports, leases, and pictures of your property. Call Trinity Multifamily at 479-452-1817 or online at trinitymultifamily.com. Trinity Multifamily, your teammate in the real estate game.
Building a home can be stressful. This is true whether you're the homeowner or the contractor. Many times these issues result in a lawsuit. If you are a homeowner or a contractor and find yourself needing legal help, call the attorneys at Kevin Hickey Law Partner. With experience representing homeowners as well as non-payment or other issues that could arise during construction, contact Brad Hull or Kevin Hickey at 479-434-2414 in the River Valley or 479-802-6560 in Northwest Arkansas, or check them out at the web at artriallawyers.com.
I want barbecue that's sliced thick, smoked long, and so tender it melts in your mouth. Sides that will fill me up like a twice-baked potato, baked beans, hand-cut fries, okra, Texas toast. You know what I'm talking about? A restaurant where the whole family can go and get a great meal for a great price. Where the owner actually comes to your table to make sure everything tastes great. I'll tell you what I want. I want Jerry Neal's.
Hi, I'm Kelly Smith, owner of Dixie Digital Imaging. Would printing from your phone or tablet make your life easier? Are you emailing files to yourself so that you can print them from your desktop or laptop? The Xerox VersaLink and AltaLink lines of network printers and multifunction printers will natively print using your phone's built-in capabilities. Apple AirPrint and Google Cloud Printing just work. To order yours today, give us a call at 783-6600 or visit dixiedigital.com. Dixie Digital Imaging, bringing document innovations to the River Valley.
Wheeler Power Sports has you covered this fall with a huge in-stock selection of ATVs, side-by-sides, dirt bikes, motorcycles, scooters, and more. Looking to sell or trade? Wheeler Power Sports is begging for your gently used off-road vehicle or motorcycle. Go to WheelerPowerSports.com to check out the full in-stock inventory or give them a call at 479-783-5822. Wheeler Power Sports, keeping the good times rolling since 1967.
Farm Credit has been a trusted friend for over 100 years. They are ag financing experts. So whether you're a longtime farmer, new to farming, or buying your dream home or land in the country, their experienced staff has a plan to fit your goals, needs, and your bottom line. From farms to land, livestock, equipment, and more, Farm Credit finances it all. Learn more at myaglender.com. Farm Credit is an equal opportunity lender.
This is Bruce Stanton, Vice President and General Manager of Pradco Fishing in Fort Smith. Our number one volume lure out of our 20 fishing brands is the Bobby Garland Baby Shad. We make them by the millions in our facility in Fort Smith, and the Baby Shad is without a doubt the number one soft plastic crappie lure in the U.S. Fish it on a light jig head or underneath a float, and you'll find it's as productive as live bait. Available at Walmart, Bass Pro Shops, Academy, LureNet.com, and tackle stores all over the place, the Bobby Garland Baby Shad.
ESPN
Good morning to the Morning Rush, everybody.
Jones hands off, and it is down to the one. Touchdown, Arkansas! Darius Howard, I believe, and the signal went up very, very quickly.
Don't miss out on Hog Reaction after every football game, presented by Game Day Lodge.
Could be one of the best Hog Reactions we've had in quite some time, regardless of the outcome, so make sure you stay tuned when you're driving back from Donald W. There's a lot of different radio stations, hitthatline.com, TuneIn, Facebook, YouTube, Twitter, and Twitch, all over the place. Hey, this morning, live from the Branson Landing, we're brought to you by Razorback Camper Sales. They're ready for you right now as fall camping season is here. Huge selection of travel trailers, fifth wheels, and pop-ups. Full prep and setup at no extra cost. Plus, you'll have access to Best Parts and Service Department. They've been in business for over 50 years. Check them out online at RazorbackCamperSales.com or come see them in Hot Springs. You're welcome to hop in this morning at 877-377-6963. I want to roll through these headlines real quick last night. A little disappointed in myself, Tommy. I'm slamming my head. Not my head, but my hand on the bar table last night because Tom Brady throws for four touchdowns, and I thought it was a good idea to leave him on my bench. Now, I do have Russell Wilson, but Tom Brady had 29 points last night.
It's what you get for doubting the old guy, you know.
Let's see. He ended three.
Us in our mid-40s, you know, we can all throw four touchdowns, right?
379 yeah. passing yards and four touchdowns. Did have two interceptions.
Would that have helped you this week?
Yes.
Now you got Russell Wilson. I ask you who you were starting, right?
I do have Russell Wilson.
Did you say Russell?
Yes.
Okay.
Russell, luckily enough. So, hopefully he tears the doors off of Indianapolis, but
so.
We'll see. Now we had the
so he may have five touchdowns.
Yeah, who knows? I hope so. Thunder Ducks need a win to open up week one, but you've got
don't doubt the old guys.
Yeah, you've got a fantastic game between the Dallas Cowboys and the Bucks last night. A photo finish. Tom Brady and company get the win. Chris Collinsworth slide. It's back. There's just a lot of excitement surrounding the NFL last night, and there should be. And you've got obviously the college football game that we're all looking forward to this weekend. But outside of that, you do have some pro hogs that are featured in Jeremy Sprinkle, Alex Collins, Cam Curl, who was incredible last year, Frank Ragnow, and Trey Flowers, recently named captains. There's a good chunk of Razorback fans that are participating this weekend. And not only should you be locked in to Saturday night at 6 o'clock, but along with that, you should be paying attention to Sunday because a good chunk of former pro hogs that'll be participating all over the place.
Yeah, we're live in Branson at the Hilton Convention Center overlooking the Branson Landing Powerboat National Racing here this weekend. Hey, this is a great sports weekend just because you got the second week of college football. We're all jacked up because of Hogs and Horns, but there's other great games. We probably haven't talked enough about some of the other matchups around the country. But then the NFL kicking off. I mean, you know, college football kind of has its stage last weekend, but this weekend you can, you know, really, and I know the passion for it. I think a lot of people, Ty, are like you anymore that you've gotten into fantasy, and it's not so much about your team, it's about your fantasy team, and you watch all these games with a different lens or a different scope now.
I'm back on the Packers train. I am throwing my, I'm not throwing my allegiance away to the Thunder Ducks, but I'm going to combine it back with the Green Bay Packers. Hopefully that will be enough to get them to the Super Bowl. Yeah. I know Brett, Aaron, and everyone else that's affiliated with that organization would like. Now, JT in Hot Springs, he texts in. He says, is it too late to have a beef because he's beefing with Jerry Jones not getting a good kicker? You got Greg Zuerlein, who at one point was one of the best kickers in the National Football League, but he did not have a good night last night.
No, and, you know, that one's going to be one that probably at the end of the year you're going to be, no pun intended, kicking yourself over not winning. You feel like it slipped through your hands if you're Dallas last night. Mm-hmm. Defending Super Bowl champions, one of the favorites to come back, a team in your own conference. I mean, there's so many things about that game last night. But I tell you what, if Tampa Bay is what we think they are, is there any reason to believe that Dallas, if they can improve on what we saw from here, can't win the NFC least and be a playoff team, and maybe you get back to an NFC championship game and see these guys again.
Quinn didn't have a great first half, but second half, now Tom Brady threw two interceptions. Rojo, Ronald Jones had a fumble at the end of the first half. So Dan Quinn, they've got some work to do, but you did like what you see if you're a Dallas Cowboys fan looking at some of that. There's some big-time games.
I mean, if Tampa Bay's the gold standard, you're not far off.
No question, yeah. Now, you do, for all you Kansas City Chiefs fans out there, you got the Browns this week, and the Browns could be the beneficiary of some Ravens injuries, whether it's Marcus Peters going down, torn ACL, Gus Edwards, torn ACL, J.K. Dobbins out for the year. The Ravens are getting depleted left and right, and that's going to leave the AFC North wide open this year. Who can end up winning between the Browns, the Ravens, the Steelers, who we just had Jared on, big-time Steelers fan, and whom I miss, the Bengals, who have no shot whatsoever. Joe Burrow, you got a couple more years before you can compete for that title, but that's NFL, and we'll talk more about that on Fantasy Football Sunday. Evan and I are set to record today. We've got, let's see, Jeff Erickson, SiriusXM Fantasy Football guy. He's going to be joining us. It'll be released later today, not only on our Hit That Line podcast network, but also as well on Sundays from 10 to 11 a.m. But back to Arkansas and Texas. That's where you want to spend the majority of your time this morning. If you haven't seen it yet, really cool decal, this 9/11 decal that they're putting on tonight. We haven't spent a ton of time talking about the significance of playing on the 20th anniversary of 9/11, but I know we have a lot of big-time United States fans listening to the program,
yeah, of course,
as the way we put it. And tomorrow night's game is going to be a sense of pride for your Arkansas Razorbacks, this country. I would think there's going to be a flyover. I would bet a lot of money there's going to be a flyover.
So I think about the state. I haven't heard that, but I would tend to agree with what your thought is. You know, I think about where I was in life and what I was doing, and then how Razorback football ties into that. Is Arkansas had, you know, just like everyone else, had their games canceled. I think they ended up scheduling Weber State or something later in the year to make up for that week. And that was the same time frame, Ty, where they were opening up the new south end zone that is now, I guess, 20 years old. I mean, that's when it was getting complete. And I remember the first game back after 9/11, they kind of dedicated that south end zone. They played Phil Fulmer in Tennessee, and it rained and it rained. And it rained. And I was sitting in those chair backs down low on the west side, and all the rain that came in was draining. And it was kind of the welcome back for a lot of our country. And they had to suspend the game because it was raining so much. So I think about this weekend in the stadium and what went on 20 years ago just from a Razorback perspective, and you lost you lost that game that weekend and came back, as no one played. With what was going on in our country. But, you know, this weekend we're going to go to that stadium and we got a new north end zone, but that south end zone was all new right in that era of 9/11. So I kind of remember that because football and sports and, of course, baseball and President Bush throwing out the first – all of it, sports kind of brought us all – it was a big part of a catalyst for the healing process.
JT in Hot Springs says the Tennessee game was a Saturday before 9/11. What he's saying is
I need to look that. I mean, it's been 20 years, but I remember being at that game. Here, let's look at that schedule. But yes, September 8th, and then 9/11 happened. Yeah, they dedicated that south end zone, and then 9/11 happened just a few days later.
It's kind of crazy to think about. So you'll see the red and white all throughout the stadium, and hopefully it'll be as color coordinated as possible. You can stop by and see our friends Robert and Elizabeth Mann at the stadium shop, whether you want a Tusk Texas shirt, a Tuck Texas shirt, or a button as well. They also have the color-coordinated chart because I know a lot of people have been trying to figure out the white or red. Are you in the white or red section?
I'm in the white.
The white section.
So okay. I bought two shirts from Robert yesterday. Now, by the time he was getting some more in, by the time we left there yesterday, they were getting thin on the sizes you needed. So they were going to order some more and try to get those in. So Ruskin and Zach will be there today, so you can stop in this afternoon, say hi between 3 and 6. And, if you're parking at Baum Walker or just wherever, you know, if you're coming, getting off there at exit 60, just come right up there on South Razorback and see them wherever you're parking tomorrow. They can take care of you.
Yeah, it's going to be a wild place up there, not just at the stadium shop, but all of Northwest Arkansas. It has the feel of a super regional where it's not just tailgating solely on Saturday. It's going to be tailgating. Really started last night, not just outside of Donald W., but all over the place on Dixon and everything else. Yeah. But I know that Clay Henry is going to be joining us shortly. We got a chance to sit down and have dinner with him last night, and he's juiced up for this game, as everyone else is. And I think Sterling laid it out perfectly earlier this week that he doesn't really care if Texas isn't as amped as we are. Because at the end of the day, he cares more. Arkansas fans care more about this game, and that's what matters. If you win it And Texas fans said, oh, we don't care about this game. Well, okay, we just beat you. Doesn't matter. So I really like Sirlin's opinionated take earlier this week about how Arkansas fans care more, and he doesn't really care whether or not Texas fans care about this game.
Yeah, that's not really going to be in the box score anywhere, or a asterisk note in the media guide 20 years from now when we're looking back on it. If Arkansas wins, that's all you really care about. So if they don't care, that's their problem. But and they've never really cared as much as Arkansas has cared about this series in totality. And they've, let's be honest, they've dominated this series. But it's always meant something because, you know, particularly beginning in the 60s and the 70s, these games were of consequence. Now, there's not a ton of consequence on this game. There's no conference title or trip to the Cotton Bowl on the line or bowl game championship for that matter. But there is a ton of pride, and it's a huge benchmark. And it's the first chance Sam Pittman has to get what I would call a signature victory. And that's what he hasn't had yet, and obviously just one season and a shortened 10-game SEC schedule. But, Ty, this would be a signature win. There's no question if Sam Pittman can pull this off. Top 15 win at home against an arch rival.
Mike and Benville text in this morning. He says, you should do a pep talk challenge this morning between Eddie and Clarksville and Coach Nutt. I think we'll at some point ask Coach Nutt what his message would be to this football team prior to entering, walking through the A, and stepping foot in Razorback Stadium, because we know in terms of a motivation, there's not many other people outside of Frank Broyles that were better in that area than Coach Houston Nutt.
And that'd be an interesting one to ask Clay. And, you know, we've never been in the locker room, but we've seen the videos of him. Who was better? Was it Nutt or Broyles? Both were good, but Nutt may have the edge there. Of course, there wasn't as much video of what Broyles had to say, but Broyles could get up in front of the Razorback Club or a pep rally or whatever. He knew how to get you – get your fired up, get the hair on the back of your neck standing up. So
I'll be surprised if Clay says Coach Nutt, but he could. I think both were supreme in that area. Hearing Coach Nutt, whether it's motivate the team, he came on this very program and gave a great improv speech about trying to beat Alabama. Some guys just have that motivation tool and factor in them. It's inside a lot of coaches. Some coaches are really talented, but not necessarily the best motivators. And Coach Nutt and Broyles, and both Nutt and Broyles in that area, it was part of their expertise that made them good. And then Broyles a great football coach.
And I think there's a difference between being a good motivator and giving a good pep speech, you know, as you're getting ready to bust through the door. And he had the rah-rah pep speech down. I mean, and we got to see it because they let the cameras in to hear some of that and see some of that. So, you know, aren't we all thankful to have those moments to relive and be able to watch what Coach Nutt did during that stretch. Hey, we're brought to you by Standard Materials Group. They have immediate openings for ready-mix drivers in the Northwest Arkansas area. If you have a CDL license without an automatic restriction, they'd love to talk to you. Whether you're in Northwest Arkansas, whether you're in Harrison and Mountain Home, they need drivers at their plant there. And they also need help in Fort Smith at their Zero Street plant. You can apply online at jobs.crh.com. They have great pay, great benefits that include profit sharing and a sign-on bonus right now as well. That's jobs.crh.com. APAC Arcola and Standard Materials Group is an equal opportunity employer.
We'll get a chance to hear what Coach Nutt has to say a little later on this morning. Really excited about that. I'll tell you what else I'm excited about. We got this notification as we're driving to Branson yesterday. The non-conference basketball schedule has already been released, and now the SEC schedules have been released. And Arkansas got theirs. The one I'm circling, as everyone else is, Kentucky last Saturday in February at home in Bud Walton Arena.
All right, so scroll on down there. Look at this stretch. That's a game that everyone's going to circle. Those are the tickets you never give away, or the Kentucky game tickets, and it's on a Saturday. But let's talk about this closing, I'll say, five-game stretch. Missouri, you know, you got Missouri, and then on February 15th, and here's your last five games in SEC play. Tennessee, Florida, the Kentucky game, LSU, and Tennessee again. My goodness, that is a rough stretch. Tennessee, home and away, Florida, then Kentucky at home. Now, you get three of those five at home, but that's the thing that's jumped out to me is how, you know, sometimes you get a front-loaded schedule. I mean, Ty, those are all going to be teams that I think are contenders for the top two or three spots in the SEC right there.
Yeah,
that's going to be a dogfight down the stretch for Arkansas.
Back-to-back Saturdays, two of them are at home, one's on the road. Alabama, Tennessee, Kentucky are the back-to-back-to-back Saturdays. You'll play Alabama and Tuscaloosa, and then Tennessee and Kentucky both at home. But Tennessee's going to have a good ball club this year. Mm-hmm. We know Kentucky just got – I think this guy's eligible for next season, but Kentucky's going to bounce back after a disastrous season for John Calisquad. And we know the impact that Arkansas fans have – during inside of Bud Walton Arena. We know the last time that Kentucky and Big Blue Nation came to town, it's one of the best college basketball atmospheres that we saw that year. So I was hoping all over the place, please be a Saturday game, please be a Saturday game, please be a Saturday game. Well, we got a Saturday game against the Wildcats, and that will be a game like the Tennessee, not as much as the Tennessee game, or sorry, excuse me, more than the Tennessee game, but there are just some really good games that I'm looking forward to. Not necessarily non-conference at home, but these home games, you got Auburn, who's going to be much better, Tennessee, Kentucky, LSU. Those are all great home games that, as you mentioned, back in the conference schedule.
Yeah, I mean, so what do you think about that closing five-game stretch there? I mean, if you need some quadrant one wins, you need to boost your metrics before the committee, before the regular season closes. You know, this could be really good or really bad. I don't know how you're going to look at it right now, but if those teams are what we think they are, there's going to be a chance for some great quality wins in the last five games.
Well, I think the best part about it is you had your schedule more front-loaded this past year, especially on the road, and you got clobbered, and Muss was still trying to orchestrate and figure things out. I know some people are starting to doubt, and I'm not going to sit here and tell you that Tommy and I didn't have a few doubts here and there. I mean, they got rocked a couple times on the road, and the games weren't even close. But luckily, they had that really tough motivational practice that one day, and Coach rallied the troops, and they got it together. So now you're going to get backloaded. Hopefully, the troops will be rallied at that point, and you could close down the stretch and get – you got the top four seed last year, right? So it would have been 13 of the – through 16, you got the 13th slot from an overall seed perspective. Now you have an opportunity, you have a chance to get an even higher seed this year. And you also have an opportunity to beat a top 15 team in Texas tonight. And that's something you referred to earlier with Arkansas playing Texas. This game not occurring in Fayetteville since 2004. You hadn't played these guys since 2014. By the way, as we've talked about this week, last five games you're 3-2. Last six games you're 4-2. And I think you're 5-4 in the last nine. So you've gotten the better of the Longhorns in the last,
That stretch into Grovey's.
20, 30 years.
If you go back nine, would that be one that Grovey played in?
I think so. Point being is this rivalry that Texas has the favor in pretty dominantly has not necessarily been the case these last few years. So you would like that trend to continue where you can keep up these winning streaks. And even the games you've lost, they've been close, particularly 0-4 in Fayetteville. Now, 0-9 wasn't because that was a team that went on to the national championship with Colt McCoy and company. But this Arkansas team, as you just referred to, has a great chance to get a signature win under Sam Pittman, something he has yet to get in his tenure at Arkansas.
Well, and you still see people that I don't think fully respect his capability as a head coach. He needs to do something to put that stamp on where he's at. So I think this is a huge opportunity for him and his program to really say, not just to the fan base here, but the pundits and the people watching from around the league, that this guy's for real.
Let's go to the phone lines. Welcome in Matt, who's in Fort Smith this morning. Matt, you're on the Morning Rush. It's Arkansas, Texas tomorrow night.
Arkansas, Texas. Well, this is more like a Texas blowout, what I'm expecting. That Arkansas team didn't even have it. Y'all had a fight with Rice. I'm over here wondering if y'all even showing up to the game.
Wasn't the score about the same as what Texas and Louisiana had?
Well, you know, it was. But y'all
Yeah. I hear you.
So what do you think happens tomorrow night, Matt? Do your Longhorns, do they get the win?
Well, I think they get the win. I really hope that Arkansas can at least put up a decent game. I hate watching those blowouts, you know.
See, this is why we hate you people. You're just smucks. You're arrogant schmucks. That's why you're so disliked universally by the sports world. And I haven't even turned Clay Henry loose on you yet. So I'm keeping him behind the cage here till 7 o'clock.
Till 7 o'clock. I might have to call back around. No, guys, I think it's going to be a fun game. It's an old rivalry. It's going to be a lot of fun to watch. I do hope it's an enjoyable experience for everybody. But I will tell you, I think the Longhorns are going to put a whooping on them. I don't think it's going to be as close as what folks are wanting it to be.
So what's the, Matt, before we let you go, what's the final score on your beloved Texas Longhorns? How many points did they put on Arkansas last night or tomorrow?
Well, it's going to be much more than that 6.5-point spread. I'd give them at least 17, but, you know, that's being
how much have you bet on it since it's so easy? How much have you bet?
I'll tell you
boy?
What, Matt. Why don't you throw $2,000 on the Longhorns, not just
two?
The money line.
It's so obvious and so easy. Well, I mean, bet the farm, right?
Well, I bet. I'll tell you guys what. I will make a bet, and I'll find something with Mr. Ty there that we can tie up. We'll get a good one with him.
Mm-hmm. That works for me. Matt, appreciate your call.
Thanks, Matt.
I wish
fun
I could say
call.
Best of luck tomorrow, but yeah. I don't really believe it or actually mean it. So, but
yeah,
it's
I don't
be
think
it.
We will.
Good stuff.
Fun stuff there. I'm not taking any crap off Texas fans this morning. We're not going to do that. So, no.
All right,
no mood for that, right?
I want to hear what Kagan and Piggott has to say. Kagan, what did you think about Matt's call?
Well, I told y'all yesterday, Texas fans are delusional. There's a lot of things that they don't know about our program and a lot of stuff, you know, about players and stuff. But I'm going to tell you one thing they're going to find out. And their quarterbacks and their receivers and their running backs are going to know the name Jalen Catalon real good, because them receivers, if you don't think they're going to be – second thinking, catching the pass in the middle of the field across his side, you're crazy. Because if y'all watched that press conference with Burks and Catalon, they asked Burks what it was like when he caught a pass in the middle going against Catalon, and he said every receiver that steps in that zone ready to catch a pass is worried because he will hit you. And I believe that's what he's going to do to Texas receivers and running backs. Heck, I'm going to make a bold prediction and say we get two picks and Catalon has a sack. And I just hope, you know, I'm ready to see John Ridgway get out there. We ain't really had a true nose guard in a long time. I feel like he's going to be a load. They say he's scrappy and tough and big and physical. I'm ready to see that. And I'm going to go ahead and give you my score prediction. I'm going to say Arkansas 27, Texas 21. Go Hogs, and let's get her done.
Appreciate the call, King. Yeah. I think a lot of people are excited to see John Ridgway step up and ultimately just play tomorrow night, Tommy.
Yep. So, you know, this is what makes this one fun. Hopefully he does have the impact we didn't get to see last week against Rice when he gets out there. You know, local service, it's the only kind of service they have at Farm Credit of Western Arkansas. The local branch staff who make and close your loan are the same people that will be there when you come back and you need help or service with your loan as well for the lifetime of the loan. Because at Farm Credit, all loans stay in-house at Farm Credit of Western Arkansas and their portfolio right here. They never, ever, ever sell their loans to a third party. So that means you'll never get a letter saying start making your payments elsewhere to a new mortgage company. Farm Credit employees are active in their local communities. They're probably people you know from church, school, and other community functions, and you can count on Farm Credit. Go to myaglender.com. That's myaglender.com for the great folks, the local folks at Farm Credit.
We'll get to Pig Suey's call to kick off the 7 o'clock hour, and you're welcome to hop in here. If you had a distaste, if you had an anger, if something was riled up inside you after what Matt in Fort Smith just called in, diehard Texas Longhorns fan, you're more than welcome to voice your disapproval and discontent for what he just said.
All right, we're live on the Branson Landing. We're inside the Hilton Convention Center Hotel overlooking the landing this morning. We're on the second floor. If you want to come by and get Clay Henry's autograph, he is right here. He'll take pictures. It is, it's just going to be a long line, but get here early for that this morning. Also telling you about the Powerboat Nationals this weekend, so come and see those down on the landing. We're going to give you more details on that. Big weekend in Branson before the Hogs game.
Loaded up in hour number two, as Tommy just mentioned, Clay is going to be joining us. Coach Nutt is going to join us at the top of the 8 o'clock hour. What is KJ Jefferson's going to look like tomorrow night? We heard from Bill Montgomery the pressure on what it is to be the Arkansas quarterback. How much pressure is KJ feeling heading into tomorrow night's game?
Burton Pools and Spas is your source for backyard fun. Cool off in your own above-ground pool this summer. Cash and carry savings at only $19.99. Don't miss this opportunity to make your backyard fun this summer. Ask about Burton's full line of Doughboy above-ground pools that are built to last for years. Cash and carry savings on above-ground pools. Going on now at Burton Pools and Spas. In Springdale and in Fort Smith. And always online at burtonpools.com. Burton Pools and Spas, your source for backyard fun.
Finding the places in life that give you joy is what Toyota is all about. Is your idea of fun filled with adventures? Like mountain biking with your good buddies? Woo-hoo! Toyota has SUVs like RAV4 and Highlander ready to take you wherever that next adventure lies. Or maybe one of our sporty stylish sedans like a Camry or Corolla to get you anywhere in style.
And we're here.
Oh, I love the theater.
Try to not fall asleep this time.
What? Me? Or maybe your happy place is in the great outdoors, and Toyota trucks can take you camping, fishing,
got one,
or whatever you love doing. Dependable Tundra and Tacoma are built to get you to the middle of nowhere and back.
Throw another log on there.
That's providing you want to come back. So no matter where you find your joy, Toyota has vehicles ready to take you there. Get $500 customer cash, or qualified lessees can lease a new 2021 Highlander L for only $289 a month for 36 months with $29.99 due at signing. Toyota, let's go places. Visit toyota.com for details. Offers available in select states and 10-4-21.
Wheels RV in Springdale wants you to seek out all the natural state has to offer this year. Explore Arkansas in a new RV from Grand Design, Forest River, KZ, Heartland, Keystone, or Alliance. All the best brands at the best prices. Enjoy peace of mind with our lifetime warranty on every new RV and a mobile service shuttle to keep you camping. So come on in and discover why Wheels RV was voted the best RV dealership in Northwest Arkansas. 5 miles west of I-49, exit 72. Seek, explore, discover. With Wheels RV.
Loading the kids in the car, brokering peace in the back seat, mastering the snack handoff without even looking. Why are simple things sometimes so complicated? Thankfully, with auto owners, insurance doesn't have to be one of them. We work with independent agents who keep insurance simple, so you can worry about more important things, like figuring out what's growing in that cup holder. That's simple human sense.
Call Kohler & Green Insurance today in Fort Smith at 484-9888 and Kohler & Green Insurance in Van Buren at 474-9888.
When fun finally returns, Bud Light legends don't just come back. They come roaring back, carrying a cooler full of Bud Lights, an inflatable dolphin, and those Velcro pads with the balls that stick to them. And this summer, with a cooler at their side, they're gonna make up for all the fun we've missed. Welcome back, Bud Light legends. It's time to take summer by the coolers. Cooler up at BudLightLegends.com. Enjoy responsibly. 2021 AB Bud Light Beer, St. Louis, Missouri.
The wave has arrived in the Coal Hill Zone, and that includes Altus, Coal Hill, Hunt, and other surrounding communities. Visit signup.waveruralconnect.com or call 1-833-4-WAVE-RC to get signed up now. Blazing fast fiber services based in Ozark. Internet starting at $49.95, TV at $32.95, and phone service $29.95 a month. Order now for the Coal Hill Zone, Arkansas Valley Electric, and Wave Rural Connect, changing the communities we serve.
Harry Robinson Buick GMC is the River Valley's truck superstore. No one has a bigger selection of new and pre-owned trucks. If you need a regular cab work truck, Harry has them, and the biggest selection you'll find anywhere. Over 60 full-size pre-owned trucks are in stock now, and over 250 pre-owned vehicles are on the lot. And for the first time in 90 days, new 2021 trucks are on the ground. When the other dealers don't have it, Harry does. The area's truck superstore, Harry Robinson Buick GMC, exit 11 off of I-540 in Fort Smith.
Did you know that you can get your car serviced or repaired without ever leaving your house? All you have to do is call Jody's Auto Service Center at 479-649-3399. Jody's will pick up your vehicle, service or repair it for you, and return it fully disinfected to your driveway. Pickup and delivery is free for jobs $75 or more. Jobs less than $75 can be picked up and returned for a $10 fee. Let Jody's Auto Service Centers handle all your service and vehicle repair needs. Call 479-649-3399.
You know, the start of the season is just around the corner, and if you're into sports betting, Bet Online is where you should go to win some money today.
Whether it's live bets during games or future bets on who you think will win the championship, BetOnline has all the latest odds, news, and information for all your online sports betting needs. Visit the website today or use your mobile device to join and receive a 50% welcome bonus on your first deposit. So before the next big game or before the season starts, head on over to BetOnline and start playing today. That's BetOnline, your online sportsbook experts.
Tommy Kraft here. When it came time for new gates and some fence repairs at my home, the Fence Man was my first call. The Fence Man does it all, from large commercial jobs to small residential repairs. Wood privacy fence, vinyl fence, commercial or residential chain link, even custom wrought iron fencing. 479-782-3936. 18 months, same as cash financing with approved credit, is now available. If it involves fencing, the Fence Man does it. The Fence Man. He ain't afraid of no work. 479-782-3936.
Now that's a dandy white perch. Big old slab.
C'est bon, succulent.
One beautiful crappie.
It's a paper mouth.
Some serious crappie.
Nice speck.
We got crappie.
They might go by different names, but all prefer the same thing. Bobby Garland, America's favorite. White perch, slab, succulent, paper mouth, crappie, speck, crappie baits.
I call it dinner.
Sportsman. This hour of the Morning Rush is brought to you by Farm Credit. From farms to land, livestock, equipment, and more, Farm Credit finances it all. Learn more at myaglender.com.
Jam-packed house here in Fayetteville, Arkansas. They're calling the Hogs. Welcome to ESPN's College Football. Tonight, the 8th-ranked Texas Longhorns take on the Arkansas Razorbacks. All season ESPN Saturday Night College Football will be broadcast in high definition, presented by Phillips and Best Buy.
Hey, this is Darren McFadden. You're listening to The Morning Rush.
Live from the Busch Light Studios.
Busch.
People who really want to have a good time won't come to a slaughterhouse. We've got entirely too many troublemakers here.
On your favorite Arkansas sports talk station.
I don't like you because you're dangerous.
That's right. I am dangerous.
Streaming live from
HitThatLine.com.
I hit the 7-iron like John Daly hits the 3.
This is The Morning Rush with Ty Richardson.
You just got to keep living, man.
And Tommy Kraft.
We follow orders or people die. Are we clear?
The Morning Rush starts right now.
Yes, sir.
It is hour number 2 of the Morning Rush as we're live from the Branson Landing at the Powerboat Nationals Grand Prix. Alongside Tommy Kraft, Clay Henry, the publisher of Hogs Illustrated, is joining us, and we've got a couple calls that we need to get to. Arkansas, Texas, tomorrow night. It's Hog vs. Horns, Tommy.
All week long, we've been talking about it. We cannot wait. We're hours away from game time, and all of it's been presented this week by Crane Hyundai of Fayetteville. Find them at cranehyundaiofayetteville.com or at 1919 West Fox Glove Drive. Also by Arvest Bank. They provide a wide range of banking services, including loans, deposits, treasury management, credit cards, mortgage loans, and mortgage services. Visit them online at rvest.com, equal housing lender, FDIC. And by World of Wireless, 877-305-DISH is their number. Get your Playmaker tailgater system. Take it to the game. Take it to deer camp. Take it anywhere you need to take TV on the go and watch the game in high definition. Also ask about the Playmaker Duo, where you can power two TVs at one time. It's 877-305-DISH for WOW, World of Wireless.
Clay, I was frankly a little bit surprised that you came up here, because that means you'd have to spend more time, not just with me, but in person with me. We had to have dinner together last night, which I thoroughly enjoyed. I just kind of sat back and listened to you and Tommy. We had our shrimp scampi. I had my strawberry cake, bread, and all that 9 yards. But thank you for not just coming, but coming in person, not mind, body, and soul to ratchet it up for the Texas game tomorrow night.
Well, there was a scary moment. You know, I drove in and was checking in, and they didn't have my name. And they said, oh, you're one of the ESPN Arkansas guys. We've got two rooms up there, and three of you guys will, you know, be two in one and one in the other. And I was like, no. I said, now, the other two boys might be in a room together, but I'm not going to be in a room with either one of them. And
so I don't blame you.
We did a little negotiating, and I turned and walked away twice, and they got the picture that I was going to leave. I wasn't going to share a room. I mean,
where's the KOA campground? I'll go there.
No, but this is pretty cool. You know, I like to fish this river. This is a trout stream, Tanicomo.
Yeah.
But I got a new way to fish it. I'm going to get in one of these power boats, and there will be nobody that leaves the dock and gets to the fishing spot faster than me.
Yep. Dan Bunning, their managing director, was by visiting during the break, and we were talking about the speed these boats are going to be at this weekend. I don't know if it's going to be the speed of the Arkansas-Texas game. You know, that's going to be pretty high level. But these things are going to be out here at like 100 miles an hour on Tanny Como. If you've ever been to the landing, that's not the widest body of water you've ever seen. And they've got these boats out here, these 12-foot boats out here running, around 100 miles. It's like going to be like NASCAR on water.
It is going to be loud.
Yes, so that'll be fun for those.
I think this is going to be cool to watch.
Some of their drivers are going to be by. We're going to visit with them in a little bit. But I know this is a week you have anticipated for more than a decade when Texas canceled their return trip, had to reschedule. They put it on the schedule. At that time, it seemed like, well, that'll never happen in 2021. Well, finally, we're here, and Texas is coming to town.
See, I was going to retire about 4 or 5 years ago, and I said, nah, I got to hang around for this game.
Yeah, so it should be fun.
This is a soul game. All right, let's welcome in Pig Suey into the conversation this morning. Pig Suey, what do you think about this game tomorrow night?
Man, I'm trying to stay positive. If Brett Bielema was able to beat Texas, that sent us in a financial tailspin of getting payroll increases for him and extra contracts. If he can do it, then I think Sam Pittman can make it happen tomorrow. Now, question I have is, did we, 60% of the game sucked last Saturday. However, that 40%, the question I have, did we play well, or was it just the Rice Owls just so beat up, worn down, and thus we didn't play that great that they just couldn't defend us any longer? What are y'all's thoughts on that?
Appreciate the call, Pig Suey. Clay, I'll let you kick this one off first.
Yeah, I don't think so. I mean, I don't think that that Rice caused any of those really those problems in the first half. I think they were out of sync, out of rhythm.
They didn't make Burks drop those passes in the first quarter.
No, I don't think so. I thought Rice played all right. But they weren't going up and down the field against Arkansas's defense. It was mainly the Arkansas offense sputtering, and I think they'll clean that up.
It was a battle of field position that Rice won, but the defense for Arkansas kept you in the ballgame by not letting them get to the end zone. I mean, that was really what the first half to me was about, is you kept putting Barry Odom's defense in bad spots, and they kept coming through. And the one time that Rice got to the end zone with a touchdown, it was aided by 2 15-yard penalties.
Yeah, I think that's something to watch. Now, Texas is all things equal, Texas is the more talented team. They should win. But the most talented team often does not win in football. It's the ultimate team game. There's so many factors. And I think the home crowd is worth a lot of points, especially in this kind of atmosphere.
How many? We asked that question earlier. If you had to pinpoint a number, ballpark it, how many points is that?
Yeah, I would say a touchdown.
Okay.
Yeah.
If Arkansas has the same field position battle this week that they're losing in the first half, you'll probably be, I'll say out of the game, but there will be a much wider margin at halftime this week than last week. So you've got to find a way to move your offense down the field and not make special teams mistakes.
Yeah, well, there's two things you can do. And it's, on the keys to victory that I wrote, it's at Whole Hog Sports, it's up right now, is you cannot turn the ball over and you cannot make kicking game mistakes. You were about to head there, I'm pretty sure. But the special teams and turnovers, you get a couple of turnovers and you play clean, be hard to beat the Razorbacks in that scenario.
Yep, absolutely.
Back to the phone lines. Welcome in Alex, who's on I-44 right now, but is originally from Rogers. Alex, you got about a minute, man. Go ahead.
I just wanted to say, that phone call from Matt, that'll get you riled up, won't it?
Yeah, it does.
We needed a reminder of why we hated Texas. He provided that. So.
Yeah, exactly. All I got to say to him is he's got a rude awakening come tomorrow night in Fayetteville on how passionate and hard our players are going to play. And they got a rude awakening joining the SEC because week in and week out, they're going to have to play hard-nosed football. They're going to have to, withstand injuries. And, they're not going to be happy about it. So that's all I got to say. And go Hogs.
Alex, appreciate the call. We got to remember this. Jalen Catalon, Treylon Burks, your two best players, NFL first rounders, They have yet to step foot in a sold-out, packed-out, primetime Donald W. Reynolds Razorback atmosphere. Not one time in their career. And they may have seen it on TV. They may have heard about it. But until you actually feel the energy that you're going to feel throughout Razorback Stadium tomorrow night, that is going to add an element to Burks's, Callon, and everyone else's on that team's game that they have yet to see since they've donned a Razorback uniform.
Going
to
be fun. All of our coverage begins at noon tomorrow right here on ESPN Arkansas. Hey, did you know that about 1 in 9 men will be diagnosed with prostate cancer at some point in their lifetime? Unfortunately, all the treatment options lead side effects with urinary problems, bowel complications, and more. However, Space OAR Hydrogel can help minimize your risk of side effects when used with radiation therapy. To learn more about the risk and benefits of Space OAR, visit spaceoar.com. That's spaceoar.com. Spaceoar.com, sponsored by Boston Scientific.
So Arkansas fans want this more than Texas fans. The Arkansas team, the Arkansas coaches want it more than the other players and the other coaches that will be wearing the Texas uniform. We just heard from Clay, and I kind of feel the same way. You, as a fan inside of Donald W., is worth about a touchdown or more tomorrow night. Again, this could break an attendance record tomorrow night in Donald W. Reynolds Razorback Stadium. The current one is Alabama. Can you beat that tomorrow night? We'll discuss it. Stay with us right here on the Morning Rush, ESPN Arkansas, and hit that line.
It's Hogs versus Horns Week, brought to you by Crane Hyundai of Fayetteville. Visit them at cranehyundaiofayetteville.com or at 1919 West Fox Glove Drive today. And Arvest Bank, ready to help you. Equal housing lender, member FDIC.
And he could go. The 15, the 10, the 5.
You know, the start of the season is just around the corner, and if you're into sports betting, Bet Online is where you should go to win some money today. Whether it's live bets during games or future bets on who you think will win the championship, Bet Online has all the latest odds, news, and information for all your online sports betting needs. Visit the website today or use your mobile device to join and receive a 50% welcome bonus on your first deposit. So before the next big game or before the season starts, head on over to Bet Online and start playing today. That's Bet Online, your online sportsbook experts.
Tommy Kraft here. When it came time for new gates and some fence repairs at my home, the Fence Man was my first call. The Fence Man does it all, from large commercial jobs to small residential repairs. Wood privacy fence, vinyl fence, commercial or residential chain link, even custom wrought iron fencing. 479-782-3936. 18 months, same as cash financing with approved credit, is now available. If it involves fencing, the Fence Man does it. The Fence Man. He ain't afraid of no work. 479-782-3936.
Now that's a dandy white perch. Big old slab.
C'est bon, succulent.
One beautiful crappie.
It's a paper mouth.
Some serious crappie.
Nice speck.
We got crappie.
They might go by different names, but all prefer the same thing. Bobby Garland, America's favorite. White perch, slab, succulent, paper mouth, crappie, speck, crappie baits.
I call it dinner.
Sammy Hagar hammered out this classic hard rock tune, "There's Only One Way to Rock." The Bible hammers out this hard rock truth, "There's only one way to God." And this world can disagree. They don't understand how this must be. And it's not my point of view, it's a fact, and you know that it's true. There's only no way that Jesus and his disciples would willingly die for what they knew to be a lie. I'm Pastor Heath from Woodland. Think about it.
The Game Day Lodge in Branson is the perfect place for corporate retreats, golf trips, and team building activities. You'll find 10 bedrooms with 19 beds for up to 28 guests, 9 bathrooms, 17 TVs, poker table, 2 kitchens, 2 laundry rooms, a fire pit, 2 gas grills, outdoor basketball court, a heated indoor swimming pool nearby, and a 10-minute drive to Silver Dollar City. Not to mention near some of the best golf courses. Just search Game Day Lodge on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, Airbnb, and VRBO.
best selection of tires for any car, truck, or commercial vehicle. Tony's Tire Service has Cooper tires and is ready to serve you to get you back on the road safely. They'll also get your vehicle fixed with brake replacements plus an alignment with the best repair guy in the area. Tony's Tire Service has been serving the River Valley for over 34 years. Come let our guys replace your tires with Cooper tires and our service department to make sure the vehicle has the best brakes and alignments. Tony's Tire Service, 7200 South 28th Street in Fort Smith. Service you can depend on.
Do you want to work for a trucking company with state-of-the-art technology? A trucking company that will give you the tools to do your job and make a great living and come home safe? Of course you do. That company you want to work for is Brent Higgins Trucking in Mulberry. Brent and Connie Higgins genuinely care about your future and your family. Brent Higgins Trucking, where you're a name, not a number. Call them today at 479-997-2366 or apply online at BrentHigginsTrucking.com.
Sir, the backyard's under attack.
What is it, Johnson?
Army worms, sir. And they're tearing everything up. Army worms. Launch a counterattack. Call Tri-Heal.
Serving the River Valley since 1986, Tri-Heal Turf and Pest Control are there for all your needs. Just give us a call at 479-782-0404, and we'll put them worms back in the barracks.
Hi folks, Larry Rath here for Rath Auto Resources, where it's finally time for our end of summer clearance. We've been busy all summer helping more people than ever get the nicer newer cars they need, and now it's time to flip our inventory. Over 120 Rath Road Ready cars, trucks, and SUVs, all priced to save you money now. Some with discounts up to $4,800 below retail. Plus, we're putting every deal together with extra for trades and fast, easy financing through the top local credit unions and the nation's best banks and lenders. If you've been waiting for the best time to buy a premium pre-owned vehicle, now is the time. And Rath Auto Resources is the place. If you're keeping the car you have, let us take care of it for you in our Meineke Car Care Center with half-off brakes, buy three, get one free on all tires, and up to a $100 rebate when you use your Meineke credit card. Get the nicer, newer car you've been wanting today and save up to $4,800 during the end-of-summer clearance at Arkansas's favorite used car dealer, Rath Auto Resources and the Meineke Car Care Center, 4515 Towson Avenue, Fort Smith, or online, rathauto.com.
Requires bank approval. Negative equity may be refinanced.
ESPN 95.3. The Morning Rush with Ty Richardson and Tommy Crabb.
Worst passes away into the end zone, incomplete on the final score. Arkansas 42, Texas 11.
Follow the show on Twitter at HitThatLineAR and on Facebook and Instagram at HitThatLine.
All right, we're live from the Branson Landing this morning as we're getting ready for Arkansas, Texas. Also getting ready for the Powerboat Nationals Grand Prix. We got some callers on the line. We're still talking Arkansas, Texas, and we'll get to all that coming up here on the Morning Rush, Tommy.
Hey, I want to remind you that the Department of Health encourages you to get your vaccine. We've seen vaccine numbers continue to climb every day in Arkansas. As that has happened, the active cases are going down. We know that the vaccines are 100% effective in preventing severe COVID. So that means it'll help keep you out of the hospital, severe COVID, and can, you know, keep you from dying. So, I mean, these vaccines are very important. Protect those around you and your family. You can find a location near you today at healthy.arkansas.gov. That's healthy.arkansas.gov or call 1-800-985-6030. As Ty mentioned, we're on the landing here in Branson. David McMurray joins us now. He's from Nashville, Tennessee. He's one of these, I called them drivers earlier. I was incorrect. They're boat pilots, Clay.
I thought for sure Dave would be a captain.
You know, but yeah, they're pilots because these things go so fast. You were telling us earlier, if you're not careful, they can get airborne pretty quick.
They can.
Yeah.
Yes, they can. So that actually happened to me the last race we had here.
You were showing us a video the last one you were here. You found out how cold the water was unintentionally, didn't you?
Yeah, I think it was a little above 50, but it was very cold. It didn't take me long to get out of that water, I'll tell you.
You don't want that thing upside down, do you?
No, not at all.
Hey, well, we're glad you're here, and we appreciate everyone having our show here this morning. Tell us what listeners that, you know, we got Arkansas, Texas going on tomorrow, so everybody's football crazy right here right now. Right. But, hey, if you're not going to the game, y'all have got a lot going on that people can enjoy and still watch the game tomorrow night.
That's correct. Saturday and Sunday both, actually.
Yeah.
It's going to be a big weekend. We've got two different sets of boats out here, two different classes, one with about a run around the 70 miles an hour, a smaller class, and then we have one that'll run north of 100, a little bigger boats. So It's going to be a good time.
Yeah, you were saying they normally y'all go about 120 because this is kind of more of a road course type, you know, NASCAR on water road course type deal that you're going to slow them down, Clay. They said slow it down about 105, 110.
Yeah.
That means from what I understand, this is like you guys fly, right?
We do. When that boat gets to be about when it gets about 90 miles an hour, it starts flying, just hovering above the water. And you're flying it at that point. It's a balancing act.
Hey, I don't know what would make me do that. What makes you do it? Is it the adrenaline rush?
I guess it is. A need for speed. I've always always liked things that go fast. So, you know, why not try a boat?
You sound like Ricky Bobby over there.
Do you have a two seater that we get Clay in? Maybe you got a jump seat or something, sidecar, anything we put Clay in?
They actually have one. I think the promoter of Powerboat Nationals, Dan's going to bring one next year. So I think they're going to run us next year out here.
It'll add years to your life, Clay.
It's just too bad it's not here this year.
I know, but I'll tell you this: if you haven't been to one of these powerboat races, it is very exciting. If you like NASCAR, you'll love this. It'll make the hair stand up on your arms. It is unbelievable.
Now, you live in Nashville, Tennessee. Correct. So you're right in the heart of SEC country. So right. Arkansas is playing Texas tomorrow. So you get a good feel there in Nashville for for the college football craziness we have in this part of the world.
You know, I stay out of that. My wife works for Vanderbilt. I'll probably get stoned to death.
My wife
works for Vanderbilt. So she comes home, Vandy. But, you know, I just stay out of the football and basketball and sports like that. I'm more the go-fast guy.
I understand. So we're looking forward to it.
What kind of car do you drive? Something that'll go fast.
Well, I have an old Camaro, 69 Camaro, and I have an old 70 Chevelle.
Yeah.
Wow.
So, yeah, 4-speed, biggest motor you can get in it, absolutely.
I had a 72 Chevelle, red with white stripes, yeah. That's awesome. When I was in high school. Yep.
Boy, if you still had that, you know what it'd be worth?
I don't. Wrecked it.
Oh, wow.
Yep.
Mine's red with black stripes, 4-speed, big block.
Oh, that's what this was.
Yeah.
Oh my goodness. It'd make your bones shake.
You'd love to get one of these boats.
Yeah. I don't know. I mean, I'm a control guy. I don't know that I could sit in the passenger seat, though. I'd want to have a hold of something.
You have to come down tomorrow and watch them.
Okay.
It's all weekend, Saturday and Sunday both. It's free to the public. It is a very, very good time.
Well, thanks for stopping by. We look forward to watching it, and we'll be around. We'll get Clay strapped in soon.
So. That sounds good.
Good luck, Dave. Good luck to you guys.
David McMurray, Nashville, Tennessee, one of the F1 pilots here this weekend for the Powerboat Nationals here in Branson.
So we're talking about signature victory that Sam Pittman has an opportunity at tomorrow night with Texas coming into town, arrival. He knows the significance of this game and everyone inside of Donald W. listening to the program right now. What it can also be, think about this. Phil and I were discussing this on Wednesday night before we did the show live from Fayetteville on Thursday, and I thought Phil laid it out perfectly. This is an opportunity. You've been beaten down. You've been ripped. You've been made fun of in the Southeastern Conference these last couple of years. Not necessarily last year, but years under Chad Morris, the last year Brett Bielema. This is a chance to re-earn respect in the SEC football-wise. Because you haven't had that. And you've got a team coming in who thinks they're going to just run not only how the conference works, but their football and everything else. And it's, I mean, I'm not going to say it just sets up perfectly, but it is right there for the taking for Sam Pittman and his team tomorrow night.
Yeah, I think that's right. But I also believe that it takes us back to the core of what we are, which is University of Arkansas Razorbacks, bring on all comers, which that was what Texas was. Texas was the measuring stick. And there isn't any doubt that Arkansas can beat Texas tomorrow night. I think the fans know it. They're coming out because they have a feeling that something magical is going to happen. And it's the history of the series suggests, I mean, Arkansas and Texas played 7 times when Texas was number one. Arkansas won 3 of those games. So there's history there that says doesn't matter what they are, doesn't matter if they've got better players, what they've done recruiting, they're going down here.
Mm-hmm. Oh, that's a good way to put it. Tommy, like when you look at this game, I'll lay it to you two gentlemen like this. Laura, Jean Ann, who wanted to go on the first date more? Was it you or Laura, or was it you or Gina? I would assume it was probably you over Gina, and it was probably you over Laura, right? Is that just a, I'm just taking a wild guess here.
She couldn't resist me.
All right, let's not lie in the airways. If I called her right now, put her on air, she said he begged me to come on. What about you and Gina? Who wanted to go on that first date more?
I think it took about three times before she would say yes.
Okay, and that brings up the point.
I don't take no for an answer. That's why I can survive in the sales world.
I was persistent.
Good, because at the end of the day, regardless of who wanted it more, who ultimately won? Whose ring is on her finger, right? Mm-hmm. Your ring is on her finger. Your ring is on Laura's finger.
I think most people will say I won.
Yeah, you won.
She's got nothing to show for this.
So the reason I'm trying to put together a bridge here. I don't know if it's going to be a Lego bridge or it's a bridge built on sand, but it doesn't matter if Texas fans, it's like what you brought up earlier. It doesn't matter if Texas fans, coaches, players say, oh, we didn't want this one as much. You guys can have it. Because at the end of the day, the only thing that matters is that L or W next to the column.
You know, the only time Texas fans say that? After they lost.
After they lost. Exactly.
Well, it didn't mean as much to us as it did to them.
Exactly.
Oh, y'all caught us off guard.
Yeah, exactly. All right, let's go to the phone lines real quick. Now, this guy currently doesn't have a ticket. And hopefully we can resolve that. Eddie, have you found a ticket for the game tomorrow night? I know you're heading up there to Fayetteville tomorrow afternoon.
That's exactly right, gentlemen. And I'm enjoying your show, as this rivalry is very special to me. I got on the hot train my first game I ever attended. This is one of the most intense rivalries in college football. It's over 125 years old. You ever heard it say it just means more? Well, that's what's fixing to take place tomorrow night in Hawktown. It's the Wupik Sioux versus the Hook'em Horns. And it's very intense and very passionate around. For fans that's never attended this game, for our players on this team have never attended this game. Let me tell you this. Tomorrow night, I hope you play like God. They always have been favored. When you walk down memory lane, that did not deter us. When you talk about phrases, hop the light, hop train, all aboard, like the whistle blow that I've used over the phrase over the years, that's where this passion comes from. And tomorrow night, we're going to burn the house down. We're not going to burn it down with fire. We're burning it down with heart and soul. And for players, this is what you're playing for. For coaches, this is what you're coaching for. You're coaching for the people and playing for the people of this great state. And they're great people. They're passionate fans. I know your heart. I've seen it many times. I'll end it with this, gentlemen. Tomorrow night, Uptown USA, that passion is on me on full display. Listen here, players. Not only are you representing yourself, not only are you representing this great university, not only are you representing, this is what you're representing, our legendary coach, Frank Brawls, our legendary athletic director, Frank Brawls. You're representing the great players that played in the Southwest Conference. And I'm sure we'll mention a few when I go down memory lane. If you'll be so gracious, Wayne Martin, Steve Atwater, Dan Hampton, Billy Ray Smith, Ken Hamlin. This is what you're playing for, gentlemen. These players I just mentioned went on and went Super Bowls, and they beat Texas, and they had heart and soul when they were on the field. Where's your heart going to be, gentlemen, tomorrow night? We're going to find out, because that opportunity is going to come knocking. And I hope you answer that bell. Let's stick it to Texas. Let them hear the echo back in Austin, Texas. And let the whistle blow. We're going to beat Texas again. And I want them in one game. That means special to me. I mentioned 1971 and 1988 in Austin, Texas.
Wrap it up,
we beat
Eddie.
Them 27-24.
Give me a hell yeah.
Oh, man. Great, hey, great add in there, Matty T.
We gave him a little extra time there since it's Texas, but I thought we were going to miss kickoff.
He had me at we're going to stick it to him.
Yeah.
I'm not sure what he really meant. I mean, what he was going to – can you imagine with a stick with a little pointy head on it? We're going to stick it to him. It's like he's going to just leave him gutted laying in the ditches.
I don't think we need Eddie with a stick anywhere near that stadium because I legitimately think that there might be some pain inflicted. I was telling earlier, Clay, now Tommy and I –
I can just sing a
Yeah.
And take that.
And it'd be justified.
You got to answer this. We kicked off the show this morning, and as much as I dislike the University of Texas, I did advocate for no violence during the course of a game. We've seen a lot of fan fights as of late. Now, Tommy says that Texas fans have souls and have limbs and other stuff. Do Texas fans have souls, Clay? Do they legitimately have souls?
I don't think so.
I don't think so either.
I've never known that to be true.
I haven't either, so I will say I'd rather not see a fight break out between Arkansas and Texas.
They may be from the dark side.
I mean, takes all kinds, right?
It might be that the Grim Reaper is ready to take them. Yeah.
I didn't say they were good souls. I just said they had souls.
They had souls.
Yeah.
They're going to the fiery place.
Yeah. Oh, jeez. All right, next caller.
That's why it's burnt orange.
Do you want some more?
Do you want some more? We want some more. All right, JW in London, you're on the Morning Rush, man. Good luck following that up for Betty.
Hey, I'm glad I'm the quiet analyst type and not the motivator because I wouldn't want to try to top that in the New York Minute or New York Century even. But I do have a little bit different take on the game than I've been hearing. I think y'all know that whenever you play somebody, or whether you go up against somebody, whether it's playing the guitar or singing or being on the athletic contest anyplace, you always play better when you've got somebody to play against that is supposed to be really good. And you raise and elevate your game. That's not just the players out there we're talking about. We've got somebody else that is sitting in this guy's shadow, and he wants to show how good he really is. And that's our offensive coordinator, Browse. Everybody has heard Sarkisian all week. He's got to be tired of it. So here's what I want to happen. I want us to take that opening kickoff. I want us to win that coin toss. I want to leave no doubt in their minds that we're going to let the offensive coordinator and his little prep school quarterback stay on the bench and think about it, and then they get down a touchdown or two, then they're going to have to start spinning that playbook, and they'll make some mistakes, and our defense will eat them up, buddy. And I am looking so forward to tomorrow. I cannot wait.
JW, appreciate the call. Yeah, Hudson Card is in for a rude awakening tomorrow night.
Yeah. Do we still have Eddie on hold? Did he stay
Sometimes
on the line?
Sometimes he just hangs on for a half hour or so.
Okay, well, let's put him back on. Eddie, are you still there?
Eddie.
He's not. Eddie, if you're listening,
rats.
Call us back. Do we want to go into the details? No. Okay. We've had a wonderful Razorback supporter. Would that be the right way? Hang on. Let me turn you back up.
I'd say a Razorback legend.
A Razorback legend has contacted us here directly. And has four tickets for you. So, Eddie, call back. Get with Matty T. He's there at Master Control today. Matty, we just need Eddie's number. Eddie, we got you four for tomorrow.
I got it, sell.
You got it? All right, so we're good. Eddie,
we're going to get out of the middle and give Eddie's number straight to my buddy.
I tell you, we got some great people in this state. And we'll just leave it at for the legend that gave the tickets, thank you.
I will tell him that, too.
All right.
Pretty awesome, man.
So Eddie's got tickets now.
That's what happens when you have friends in high places like Clay Henry.
Yeah.
So
or low places like me and you.
Yeah. Friends in low places. All right, Clay, let's get into your keys to the game. You talked about it a little bit earlier. I want to dive into it a little bit. We heard what JW thinks about the key to the game. We heard what Eddie in Clarksville thinks about some of the keys to the game. What does Clay Henry think about some of the keys to the game? Give me just a second. We'll get into that.
All right, the keys to the game are brought to you by Hashtag Managed IT. How about that for an improv? Hashtag Managed IT Services. Hey, if your software, your hardware, your router, your computer network is causing you problems at work, call our buddy Daryl because he saved our bacon about a week ago. We had a router that just said no more, and he took care of it within an hour. And when you have a problem with your computer network, you've got to have someone that can fix it quick. That's Daryl. 479-802-4978. 479-802-4978. The man you can count on, Daryl at Hashtag Technology without the headaches.
You looked at me like, when you're reading that, like, you could fix your router, right? No,
you don't even know the difference between the router and the whatever else thingamajig.
You know, it was funny when we were doing some work getting started with DSL at our new house 4 years ago, and they told me I needed a router modem. Mm-hmm. I bought something, and the guy showed up. He says, "This isn't what you needed." So, we ended up renting theirs.
Yeah,
you
need Daryl. So, what are the keys to the game tomorrow?
Well, I mean, it's multiple. I mean, football is. But first of all, I think you got to be special in special teams, and you have to win the turnover battle. Those two things will get you to the fourth quarter, I think. And then you get to, can you stop the run and can you run it? When you get to the end of these big games, if you're able to run the ball, that's a sign of success, and that you'll be able to control the tempo and you'll be able to force them to do some things defensively to try to stop that. Coach Broyles, when he first came to Arkansas, he says against great teams, against Texas, you have to be able to throw the ball. So I think that Arkansas has to take advantage of the passing game, and Treylon Burks and Devion Warren and these guys, I mean, they've got to hit some passes, and they cannot be 3 for 12 in third downs, and that's what they were against Rice. And you cannot leave your defense on the field by not converting third downs. And I think it's going to come down to the RPO game and KJ Jefferson making some things on his, on his own, some running plays. Not just those quarterback draws, but the RPO plays.
So I'm of the opinion for Burks to have a big game, you got to have another threat at wide receiver, whether it's Warren or Jackson or somebody's got to be a threat to free him up where he doesn't get double-teamed and bracketed.
Tyson Morris might be the guy.
So that was my question. Who's the guy that can take some of the pressure off Burks so he can shine?
I think it's Tyson Morris. He had a great camp, looked good. He got the touchdown in the end zone. Looks like he can get some separation, and Texas has a really solid defense, and at some point this year they probably have a good defense. Pete Kwiatkowski, who was Chris Peterson's defensive coordinator forever and ever, both at Boise State, then at Washington, $1.7 million was probably the best hire that Steve Sarkisian made, and they don't blitz a lot. They play sound, fundamental football, and they do not give up much in the running game. So that's the nose guard in the middle, the matchup, Coburn against Stromberg, that's something to watch. And if Arkansas has to double-team that nose guard, it really changes things, the dynamics of what you can do inside with running, both with Treylon and Rocket.
Let's take a quick phone call. Charlie and Camden, you got about a minute to get your take on this Arkansas-Texas game, buddy.
You guys hear me?
Yeah, go ahead, man.
Clay, I agree with you. We got to make a couple of plays down the field. I'm not calling me and say I want to correct what I said. I said we played awful as a unit the other day, but I do agree our defense played great in the first half. Only reason we didn't get beat just the other day. But, we got to cut out the penalties. We're going to have to hit a pass or two down the field. I don't know if Davion Warren is 100% yet. Obviously, probably not. But if we can hit a couple passes down the field and back them off a little bit, we got to be able to run the football a little bit. Some, people called in yesterday late and saying we're going to lose 38-17. You know what? I think we have a chance in this game, and I'm not going to count us out. I think if it's a four-quarter game, if we make it a four-quarter game, we keep it close, give ourselves a chance at the end, we got a chance to win this football game. So I think it'll be trying to be in the high 20s, maybe scoring 28-24. But I'm going to go 28-24 Arkansas. I think we can win this football game.
Charlie, appreciate your call. Appreciate your optimism. Here's what I'll say. Remember this. If it somehow, some way gets to the fourth quarter and it's close, none of the pressure's on Arkansas. You can say you're at home, they want to please their fans. All the pressure's on the Texas Longhorns, Steve Sarkisian in year one, and them not wanting to drop the second game in the season against what they consider an inferior opponent, period. All the pressure's on the Horns, not the Hawks.
And if it comes down to the fourth quarter and you got to have the kicking game to win the game, I don't know why anybody would be nervous.
Yeah, I think you're going to get a good game from Treylon Burks. I think if you watch the end of the Cowboys-Tampa Bay game where they threw the back shoulder pass and Receiver got a little separation. He's the guy that can do that for Arkansas.
Hey, we're brought to you by Gaston's White River Resort. 870-431-5202 is the number to call Clint and the crew at Gaston's. If you're planning that fall trip, you're planning that getaway, now's the time. Don't forget about their dinner specials this weekend, as you can stop in for a great meal. It could be a great place for a victory dinner, maybe after the game if you're not headed, or Sunday brunch on Sunday morning. You can make dinner reservations or brunch reservations for this weekend with the same phone number, 870-431-5202. We've been telling you about fall getaways. October's a busy month there, so if you'd like to get there in October, call now and book your reservation. Gaston's White River Resort, a first-class time. Every time!
Arkansas's home for the best sports talk.
All right, you go do the research.
You're listening to The Morning Rush.
Your company is known for top pay and great salaries, but how do your benefits compare to the competition? Hi, this is Brett Good with Henderson Phillips. In today's competitive labor market, great pay is no longer enough. Call me at 479-651-2292 and let's discuss your benefit plans to make sure your company has what it needs to attract and retain the best talent. I am Brett Good with Henderson Phillips. Call me today, 479-651-2292. That's 651-2292.
In the mood for a top-shelf night? 906 Cocktail and Cigar Lounge has your number. Sit back, relax, and enjoy select wines, top-shelf spirits, and handcrafted cocktails in a rich, comfortable, sanitized setting with state-of-the-art air filtration. Indulge in one of our delicious appetizers, sandwiches, salads, or specialty items for carryout or dine-in. Open Tuesday through Saturday. Stop by 906 Garrison Avenue in Fort Smith. 906 Cocktail and Cigar Lounge, defining nightlife in downtown Fort Smith.
Tired of constant computer issues at work? And who knows what the real problem is? Is it the router? No, it's the hardware. Wait, they said it was the software. Call Hashtag Managed IT Services. Their multifaceted approach to IT support guarantees that everything is working at optimum performance. And Hashtag prevents the small problems from becoming big issues. Hashtag Managed IT Services in Van Buren. 479-802-4978. That's 479-802-4978. Hashtag technology without the headache.
Did you know that you can get your car serviced or repaired without ever leaving your house? All you have to do is call Jody's Auto Service Center at 479-649-3399. Jody's will pick up your vehicle, service or repair it for you, and return it fully disinfected to your driveway. Pickup and delivery is free for jobs $75 or more. Jobs less than $75 can be picked up and returned for a $10 fee. Let Jody's Auto Service Centers handle all your service and vehicle repair needs. Call 479-649-3399. Jody's Auto Service Center.
River City Bistro is Fort Smith's favorite place for lunch, dinner, and brunch. Open 7 days a week, both on the patio and cozy dining room. River City Bistro, locally owned and open weekdays 11 till 8, Saturdays 10 till 8, and Sundays 10 till 3. Want River City Bistro curbside to go? Just search on Facebook or Instagram for River City Bistro or go to rcbistro.com. River City Bistro, 7320 Rogers Avenue in the Stonewood Village Shopping Center.
September is here, and at Frank Rowe Furniture, it's time to sell, sell, sell. Everything's on sale. Made in the USA furniture, family-owned, and serviced after the sale. Also, we have in-store, no-credit check financing. I want you to remember one name, Frank Rowe Furniture, located at 405 Fort Street in Barling, Arkansas, or check us out on Facebook. Frank Rowe Furniture, best seats in the house.
Was your roof damaged by recent storms? Don't fall victim to out-of-town contractors and fly-by-night repairmen. Trust the local roofing professionals at Able Roofing. Call their local number, 474-0006, for a free roof inspection. Never trust something as important as the roofing system on your home to a storm chaser. Able Roofing, 474-0006, will work with your insurance company. Call now for your free roof inspection, 474-0006. Able Roofing, the hometown roofers.
Better make some room in the history books, because there's a new chicken classic to write about. Try the new classic chicken sandwich for $5.99 from B-Dubs, and sink your teeth into juicy hand-breaded chicken topped with pickles and mayo between a rich challah bun. Plus, it comes with fries, and it's $5.99 for a limited time. Don't wait for that price to be history. Get here for the new classic chicken sandwich from Buffalo Wild Wings.
Available at participating locations for a limited time. While supplies last, taxes extra. Add-ons extra, delivery subject to availability. Fees may apply.
Harry Robinson Buick GMC is the River Valley's truck superstore. No one has a bigger selection of new and pre-owned trucks. If you need a regular cab work truck, Harry has them, and the biggest selection you'll find anywhere. Over 60 full-size pre-owned trucks are in stock now, and over 250 pre-owned vehicles are on the lot. And for the first time in 90 days, new 2021 trucks are on the ground. When the other dealers don't have it, Harry does. The area's truck superstore, Harry Robinson Buick GMC. Exit 11 off of I-540 in Fort Smith.
ESPN 95.3.
Arkansas football. It's the players running through the A. Hog hats. It's more than 70,000 fans calling Woo Pig Suey.
Woo! Oh, yes, sir!
Guys, I've got just one thing I want to say to you. Touchdown, Arkansas!
Arkansas wins the national championship! The Arkansas Razorbacks have completed the dream season!
This is your Hog Update on the Morning Rush. Brought to you by Mr. Sparky. Need a licensed electrician to service your home? For one of their local pros, call 888-8-SPARKY.
We really haven't strayed too far from talking Arkansas, Texas this week, but one big note came out yesterday about this Razorback basketball program, not just the Arkansas Razorbacks, but the entire SEC release, the conference schedule. And you have a back-loaded stretch. If you haven't seen it, you can go to ArkansasRazorbacks.com. We'll also have all the info on HitThatLine.com. The biggest one, the one everyone has circled, last Saturday in February, the Kentucky Wildcats come to Bud Walton Arena.
Yeah, and that's part of a five-game stretch to close the conference season. I think it's tough. You play Tennessee at home, go to Florida, then you mentioned the Kentucky game at home, LSU, and then Tennessee again. It's two of Tennessee, LSU, Kentucky. Woo! I mean, Clay, that's going to be a tough stretch. Ty, that's going to be a tough stretch. If you need some quadrant one wins, you're going to have a chance probably to get them there in those last five games, Ty.
Down the stretch, and hopefully they do just that. And that's going to do it for your Hog Update, and it's brought to you by Mr. Sparky. All right, let's go ahead.
You don't have to put up with any malarkey. Call 888-8-SPARKY.
All right, this guy currently leads our picks this morning as we welcome in Sean from the Fence Man. Sean, you're currently up, let's see, you've got 93 points. Tommy, you're right behind him with 90 points, and Clay and I are neck and neck at 97. So this is a big week as we get into it.
Fenceman Friday Picks. Call the Fenceman for all kinds of fences, controlled access, and custom iron projects. 479-782-3936. The Fenceman. We ain't afraid of no work.
So we are going to pick Arkansas, Texas down the stretch, but we're going to keep it top 25 this week. A good number of top 25 games, and we'll go outside the SEC first before we get inside the Southeastern Conference and start with where College Game Day is at this weekend. You've got a top 10 matchup between Iowa and Iowa State. The Hawkeyes are underdogs in this one by 4 points. Sean, welcome in this morning, man. It's good to have you. Are you excited to get these picks going? Excited to keep your lead up?
Well, yeah, most certainly.
All right, man, let's get it going. Well, Clay, I'll let you kick this one off first this morning. Are you going to take the Hawkeyes or are you going to take the Cyclones? Again, Iowa State is a 4-point favorite at home in Ames.
Hang on, my fault.
I go with Matt Campbell and the Cyclones.
Okay. Tommy, are you going to go Matt Campbell or are you going to go Kirk Ferentz?
I'm going to go with Iowa State, too.
Iowa State. All right. Sean, are you going to be different or are you going to stay with Iowa State names?
Man, I don't know. I'm on the fence on this one. You know, I don't know much about either team, so do I want to pick with everybody else to maintain my lead or go crazy? But I'll stay Iowa State.
Say Iowa State. Well, that's a chance for me to get points, but I truly think that Matt Campbell and Prix Hall and those guys are going to ultimately end up winning this game. So I'm going to go Iowa State as well in this one. All right, next game we'll pick this weekend. How about Oregon, Ohio State? Now, this is going to be a fun matchup between Mario Cristobal and Ryan Day. Oregon's the number 12 team in the country. Ohio State's number 3. This is the 11 o'clock game on Fox. Now, the Buckeyes are 10-point favorites in this one, Tommy.
Yeah, and, you know, this is kind of the kickoff to the day. I like Ohio State. They're at home. I think on the road, Oregon would probably have a chance making Ohio State travel a couple of time zones away. Ohio State favored by 14.5 in this game. I'll take the Buckeyes.
Clay, which way
Oregon
would you like to go?
I got Oregon.
Oregon, okay. Do you think they'll
quack, 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 quack.
Do you think they win or just cover?
I think they – I don't have to say. Okay. Except to say that I think they're going to cover.
Okay. Sean, do you want the Ducks and the Quack Quack, or do you want the Ohio State Buckeyes? They've got to win by 11 or more for you to win.
Well, I'll tell you what. When I watch the games, my wife loves the Oregon Ducks. She thinks they have the best uniforms in all of college. So they're so that's the reason why she roots for the Ducks. So I'm going to pick the Ducks.
Okay. And you picked Ohio State?
I got Ohio State.
I think I'm – I don't even know who Oregon's quarterback is, but Stroud looked a little shaky last week. So I'm going to take Oregon. I'm going to leave you on the island there, Tommy.
Great.
So we've got three on –
looking forward to y'all losing.
Three on the Oregon Ducks, and then you're going to remain in Ohio State. All right, last SEC game before we get into Arkansas.
That's a bad place to be, though, when you got to root for Ohio State. Yeah, that's just an awful feeling.
It kind of is. let's go to Denver, yep. Colorado, and watch Texas A&M and the Buffs take on each other. The game's not being played in Boulder. It's being played in Denver. Sean, I'll let you kick this one off. Do you think that Colorado, they're 17-point underdogs. Do you think they can cover the spread against Texas A&M? Or do you think that Texas A&M blows them out in their own state?
I got to go to the Aggies. You guys always know if you're going to pick an Aggie game, I have to pick the Aggies.
Got
to
pick the Aggies.
It saves my rear at home.
That's a proper way to look at it.
I got Colorado.
Colorado.
I'll take Colorado in the points. A&M wins, but Colorado will be within 17.
It's always difficult going up to a Colorado City and playing football. Arkansas knows that all too well, going to Colorado State and losing.
Rocky Mountain High in more ways than one, right?
Haynes Keene, I think, is looking to redeem himself after three interceptions this past week. So I'm going to go Texas A&M, gets the points, and they're going to ultimately win by 18 or more in this football game. All right, the game we've all been looking forward to tomorrow night, 6 o'clock, Arkansas and Texas. The line I'm seeing is 4.5 on Yahoo Sports, so I guess we can – keep it right there. Do you have another line?
ESPN says 7.
7?
So that's quite a
difference.
Let's
go 7. I
says
think
Texas minus 7.
I like the 7 line more. Gives Arkansas a chance to cover a little bit more. Guys, or at least push. Guys, Clay, I'll let you get this one. Does Arkansas cover the spread? We'll let you get into your actual prediction coming up at the very end of the program.
I think Arkansas is going to win the game outright. But so I don't have to have that. I just have to have them covering, right?
That's all you got to do.
Take Arkansas.
Well, in the magazine this week for Clay, I said 35-28 Texas. That'd be right on the number. I'll take Arkansas, though, in 7 points.
Okay. Arkansas, so you got to lose by 7. I think in the magazine I said 30-27 Texas, and I'm unfortunately going to keep it right there. I think Arkansas covers, but I think Texas ultimately wins this football game. John, you're last but not least. Are you taking the Hogs or are you taking the Horns?
Oh, my gosh. We could have so much fun with this one, couldn't we? But you know we're going to go with the Hogs. I think they're going to win. I think they'll cover the points as well.
So, going to be a great game tomorrow. Now, you getting to go to the game?
This one I don't have tickets for, no.
So,
my insider on this one gave them to somebody else.
Oh, no.
Oh, no.
Can you make a fence with downward hook'em horns on them?
Ooh, hey, you know what? I've got a guy who works for me, has a Plaz table, and we can make it just about anything you want. So, yes, sir, we can do a downward hook 'em horns. If you talked about putting a trout on your gate, I can Plaz cut you out a nice iron fish to put on your gate. You need it, we can do it.
We need the trout, and then the tail of the trout turns into horns at the end that are down. That's what we could do.
Oh, that'd be great.
It would be a devil trout.
Yeah, we'll turn that into a devil trout. Hey, Sean needs more help to put downward horns down on some fences. Sean, you're still looking to add great people to the team. 1213 North 32nd Street in Fort Smith is the place to apply.
Yes, we need good help. We are very blessed with lots of fence. A lot of customers are coming to us. We're just, there's two things. You do have to wait for us, yes, and I apologize for that, but you are waiting for a quality fence, and that's the reason why I'm looking for good quality employees or team members to come on and build fence with us.
I was just thinking, though, if you called someone else for a quote and they could start next week, that ought to tell you all you need to know right now, right? So,
if they're that open, if you're in the fence building business and you can build a fence next week, I would be afraid to see what your fence looks like. I'll
That's
be honest.
Exactly what I was trying to say. Sean, enjoy the games this weekend, and we'll see you in studio next Friday.
Thanks, sir. You have a great day.
All right, Sean with the Fence Man again. If you're looking for a great company to work for with top pay, great benefits, go by the Fence Man and apply in person, 1213 North 32nd Street in Fort Smith.
Clay, I don't think I've ever run as fast in my life than to run down to that breakfast buffet and get his food right before we got into this past segment.
I sent a picture of that to Gene Ann, that plate that needed sideboards. You're going to be in trouble when you get back to Norfolk.
He basically filled up a plate that would feed an army.
It would.
You ate the whole thing.
No, I didn't eat the whole thing.
Coming up.
Not yet. He will in the break, though.
Coach Houston joins us on the other side to kick off hour number three.
Burton Pools and Spas is your source for backyard fun. Cool off in your own above-ground pool this summer. Cash and carry savings at only $19.99. Don't miss this opportunity to make your backyard fun this summer. Ask about Burton's full line of Doughboy above-ground pools that are built to last for years. Cash and carry savings on above-ground pools. Going on now at Burton Pools and Spas. In Springdale and in Fort Smith. And always online at burtonpools.com. Burton Pools and Spas, your source for backyard fun.
Finding the places in life that give you joy is what Toyota is all about. Is your idea of fun filled with adventures? Like mountain biking with your good buddies. Woo-hoo! Toyota has SUVs like RAV4 and Highlander ready to take you wherever that next adventure lies. Or maybe one of our sporty stylish sedans like a Camry or Corolla to get you anywhere in style.
And we're here.
Oh, I love the theater.
Try to not fall asleep this time.
What? Me? Or maybe your happy place is in the great outdoors, and Toyota trucks can take you camping, fishing,
got one,
or whatever you love doing. Dependable Tundra and Tacoma are built to get you to the middle of nowhere and back.
Throw another log on there.
That's providing you want to come back. So no matter where you find your joy, Toyota has vehicles ready to take you there. Get $500 customer cash, or qualified lessees can lease a new 2021 Highlander L for only $289 a month for 36 months with $29.99 due at signing. Toyota, let's go places. Visit toyota.com for details. Offers available in select states and 10-4-21.
The Fence Man, the company you can trust when it comes to building quality fencing and gates, is growing and looking for quality people to join the Fence Man team. If you are a fence builder or have building experience or you have welding skills, apply in person at 1213 North 32nd Street in Fort Smith. The Fence Man offers great pay, health, dental, and vision benefits. Join the top fence building team in the state. The Fence Man. Apply today in person. The Fence Man is an equal opportunity employer.
Farm Credit has been a trusted friend for over 100 years. They are ag financing experts. So whether you're a longtime farmer, new to farming, or buying your dream home or land in the country, their experienced staff has a plan to fit your goals, needs, and your bottom line. From farms to land, livestock, equipment, and more, Farm Credit finances it all. Learn more at myaglender.com. Farm Credit is an equal opportunity lender.
Only 10% of collision repair shops achieve ICAR Gold Class status, the highest training level recognized in the industry. Evans Body Shop is proud to be one of them. We know the latest repair techniques, how to find hidden damage, and repair your car's critical safety features so they work properly again. We invest in training because we would never cut corners with your family's safety at stake, and neither should you. Get your vehicle repaired at Evans Body Shop, where your safety is our top priority. Evans Body Shop, 412 Gordon Avenue, Van Buren.
Evans Body Shop, where we meet the nicest people by accident.
Have your travel plans changed? Looking for a place that's close to home and keep your family safe? Gaston's White River Resort is located on the beautiful White River. They offer private accommodations in their lodges and cabins. Most cabins have a fully equipped kitchen, or let their restaurant staff deliver to your cabin. Call 870-431-5202 and change your plans to Gaston's White River Resort. Gaston's White River Resort, a first-class time every time.
Doe's Eat Place, serving award-winning steaks, has now added lobster tail and salmon to the menu. You can also enjoy delicious appetizers along with your choice of drinks from the largest selection of wines, beer, and liquor in the River Valley. Doe's Eat Place is open Tuesday through Thursday, 5 till 9, and Friday and Saturday, 5 till 10. Reservations are recommended. Call 784-9111. That's 784-9111. Doe's Eat Place, 422 North 3rd Street, Fort Smith.
Do you own apartment complexes, condos, and rental property? Then you have made a great investment. Now make another great decision by calling Trinity Multifamily to help you maximize your return. Trinity Multifamily offers full-service property management, marketing, leasing, sales, and all the services to make your cash flow. Take the hassles and frustrations out of ownership and call Trinity Multifamily at 479-452-1817 or online at trinitymultifamily.com. Trinity Multifamily, your teammate in the real estate game.
Hi folks, Larry Rath here for Rath Auto Resources, where it's finally time for our end of summer clearance. We've been busy all summer helping more people than ever get the nicer, newer cars they need, and now it's time to flip our inventory. Over 120 Rath Road Ready cars, trucks, and SUVs, all priced to save you money now. Some with discounts up to $4,800 below retail. Plus, we're putting every deal together with extra for trades and fast, easy financing through the top local credit unions and the nation's best banks and lenders. If you've been waiting for the best time to buy a premium pre-owned vehicle, now is the time, and Rath Auto Resources is the place. If you're keeping the car you have, let us take care of it for you in our Meineke Car Care Center with half-off brakes, buy three, get one free on all tires, and up to a $100 rebate when you use your Meineke credit card. Get the nicer, newer car you've been wanting today and save up to $4,800 during the end of summer clearance at Arkansas's favorite used car dealer, Rath Auto Resources and the Meineke Car Care Center, 4515 Towson Avenue, Fort Smith, or online, rathauto.com.
Requires bank approval. Negative equity may be refinanced.
ESPN Arkansas weather.
For today, plenty of sunshine, our high this afternoon into the low 90s, mainly clear mid-60s tonight. And then tomorrow, lots of sunshine, our high into the lower 90s. Sunday, blue sky and sunshine, our high will be into the lower 90s. I'm Sally Russell with your forecast on ESPN Arkansas.
Weather is brought to you by Ramos Roofing, specializing in all roofing needs. 479-420-9903.
You're listening to The Morning Rush, live from the Busch Light Studios on ESPN 95.3, KERX Paris, Fort Smith.
Jam-packed house here in Fayetteville, Arkansas. They're calling the hug. Welcome to ESPN's College Football. Tonight, the 8th-ranked Texas Longhorns take on the Arkansas Razorbacks. All season ESPN Saturday Night College Football will be broadcast in high definition, presented by Phillips and Best Buy.
Hey, this is Darren McFadden. You're listening to The Morning Rush.
Live from the Busch Light Studios.
People who really want to have a good time won't come to a slaughterhouse. We've got entirely too many troublemakers here.
On your favorite Arkansas sports talk station.
I don't like you because you're dangerous.
That's right. I am dangerous.
Streaming live from
hitthatline.com.
I hit the 7-iron like John Daly hits the 3.
This is The Morning Rush with Ty Richardson.
You just got to keep living, man.
And Tommy Kraft.
We follow orders or people die. Are we clear?
The Morning Rush starts right now.
Yes, sir.
So if you guys were listening around 7:30 this morning, you heard from Eddie in Clarksville and his motivating speech to this football team. Well, there is not many people better than this guy who's about to join us, Coach Houston Nutt. We'll get to Coach coming up in just a bit.
Hogs versus Horns all week long right here on The Morning Rush and ESPN Arkansas and hitthatline.com. It's presented by Crane Hyundai of Fayetteville. Find them at cranehyundaiofayetteville.com. And by Arvest Bank, they provide a wide range of banking services, including loans, deposits, treasury management, credit cards, mortgage loans, and mortgage services. Visit them at arvest.com, equal housing lender, member FDIC. And by Wheels RV, 5 miles west of Exit 72, off I-49 in Springdale, the best brands like Grand Design, Forest River, KZ, Heartland, Keystone, and Alliance, all at the best prices with a lifetime warranty. Wheels RV, seek, explore, and discover with Wheels RV.
Coach, thank you so much for taking time out of your morning to join us. Better win for you personally, 2000 at the Cotton Bowl or 2003 in Austin, Texas?
Man, that's a tough one because both of them are so sweet. 2000, you know, that was the first win, I think, first bowl victory in about 15 years. So that was a great one. But anytime you go on the road, though, and go in a hostile environment and win, there's nothing like that either. So that's just too hard to pick.
Well, they're both great ones, Coach. And I was listening to you talk about the game earlier this week, and one of the things that you had the luxury of is Coach Broyles called you on Thursday night and just kind of reassured you, hey, you've been doing what you're doing. You guys are going to have a great game on Saturday. What would your message be to Coach Pittman heading into this high-octane game, a game that hasn't been played in Fayetteville since 04? What's your message to Coach?
Well, you know, I think the biggest thing is the preparation is so important. And so you just feel like they've had a good week. Everybody's going to be laser-focused. And so far as that part of it, you just want your players to focus on their job. And then as closer as you get to the game, the atmosphere is going to be it's going to be so good. Because just remember, it wasn't too long ago, last year, COVID, it was one of the hardest things to me, just watching a game without the noise, without the band, the cheerleaders, the atmosphere, the passion. So all that's back. And so the players realize that. They know that. And so my message, hey, you're ready to go. You got them ready. You turn them loose. And now, especially with the emotion, the passion, the fans are going to play every play with you. You turn it loose. You turn it loose. And this is why this is one of the greatest games there is. And I think the first 5 minutes, you know, are always very, very important, especially at home, because that's where the home field advantage comes in. I always felt like we were 3 to 7 points up when you're at home. And so you take advantage of that. And so I just know Coach Pittman from outside looking in, I know that they'll correct the special teams. They'll correct the things and fix up the things from the first week, first game. And now you go put it on the field. And you just let that atmosphere take over. You're almost on automatic pilot. And that's the way you want your team. You've had great preparation. You're ready to go. Now it's on automatic pilot. Let's go. And even if you make a mistake, we're going 100 miles an hour.
Coach, one of my good friends, someone I officiate high school football with on Friday nights, is one of your former players, Sparky Hamilton. And he's always relaying one of your quotes, best days of your life. Man, it's the best days of your life. Why was that so important to you to express that to your team before big games, during practices? Because I can tell you this, it stuck with Sparky for a while. Why was that such an important message for you?
I love Sparky Hamilton.
Oh, he's great.
You know what's important about that to me is don't forget about this moment, you know, because they go by so fast. And always remember talking to the team in the very first team meeting. I'd ask the seniors to stand up, and you knew that, hey, this is important, so important to them because they only have about 3 months left. But now I ask the freshmen to stand up, and I would ask them, now, how long do you think it's going to be before you're a senior? You're going to be standing up as a senior. And, you know, they'd have a look like, that's going to be forever before I'm a senior. And this is why we tell them, nuh-uh, it's the best days of your life because it is going by fast, and it will happen so fast. So you want to enjoy and take advantage of every moment. And so where I'd always would get them, where the heat index during 2-a-days would be maybe 108, 110, and during stretch lines, you know, they're hitting about that 10th practice, and I'd yell out, the best days of your life. And they're saying, yeah, right. And, you know, but it's like Sparky, though, when you fast forward 10, 15 years afterwards, it truly was. It was truly the best days of their life. And so you just want them to enjoy the moment, embrace it, because it is the best days of your life.
Coach, it's Clay Henry. Can you take us back to maybe what you ever heard from Wilson Matthews about playing Texas? Or maybe what somebody else told you that Wilson would say before those games?
Yeah, you know, Wilson would always come to practice and set up on that little concrete cornerstone up there, you know, with the chair with Coach Broyles, and they'd watch practice. And, you know, he would always say to me that, you know, Texas is always going to have better athletes than you played. You know, in their mindset in the Southwest Conference days, the TCU, Texas Tech, SMU, you always had respect for those teams, but Texas, you know, would always have better, bigger, faster athletes. So you got to play smarter. You got to be on point with your assignment, what you're supposed to do. And everybody held everybody accountable. The thing about Coach Matthews, the old Little Rock Central man, is, you know, he demanded physicality. He wanted to hit you in the mouth. And that was the mindset of, hey, they may be faster, they may be a little bigger, but we're going to hit them, and we're going to hit them for 60 minutes. And so, again, you know, I just think the lessons that you learn from Coach Wilson Matthews and Coach Bulls is that physical mentality of being a smart team. You don't clip anybody. You don't hit anybody in the back. You don't hit anybody out of bounds. You don't let them block a punt or take a kickoff back. All those little things, the four don'ts in the kicking game, all of those things to me always, when you bring up Wilson Matthews and Frank Rowe, that's the first thing I think about.
Coach Houston Nutt with us here on the Morning Rush. Coach, you had quite a dandy dual threat quarterback in Matt Jones. Got a chance to talk with him earlier this week, and just what he could provide on the field when things broke down, when the defensive line crashed, and he was just able to make plays with his feet. Arkansas really hasn't had that guy until the guy that's suiting up for quarterback for the Razorbacks now, KJ Jefferson. What dynamic does he have to this football team, and how much is he going to have to use his legs tomorrow night?
Yeah. The thing about Matt Jones was always had ice water in his veins, and every defensive coordinator from Joe Lee Dunn or anybody after the game, they would come to me and say, I didn't realize how fast Matt Jones was. The safeties would take a bad angle, bad step, and then he outruns them. And so the thing about KJ Jefferson, in today's world, you've got to be able to extend the play. If a left tackle or right tackle, if he misses one, misses a block, and it's going to happen three or four times a game where somebody may miss somebody, that's where your quarterback, that's where your 12th man comes into play. And that's what Matt Jones had. So, KJ, the biggest thing for him to me is you don't have to be Superman. Be yourself. But when you can use your legs, you can extend the play and adjust on the run, on the move. Man, it makes all the difference. It just gives a defensive coordinator a headache when they think they have everybody buttoned down and covered, and then you can still move the chains. And that's what Matt Jones always was able to do for us. He was able to move the chains, make things happen. But the biggest thing, I think, for a quarterback in a game like this, you always want to try to make a play, but what's important is know there's a fine line. Hey, don't force it. It's okay to throw it to grandmother in the third row sometimes. Hey, let's just re-huddle. Let's get back on the line of scrimmage and let's go again. But you don't turn it over.
Coach, we were talking about Sparky a moment ago. He was from Lufkin, Texas, and you always recruited a great group from Texas. And when you had these games, what, from a coach's perspective, did it mean to you for them that, hey, maybe Texas had said, you're not good enough to go here, or they chose Arkansas over Texas? What did this game and this particular week mean to them personally, playing for Arkansas against the school, the flagship school in their home state?
Well, you hit on something that's really, it's really big. It's a great question, because I live pretty close to Tony Bua, and I can tell you, he was not recruited. He was a Texas boy, but he moved to New Orleans. He didn't get recruited by LSU, and they have this mindset. Okay, and they have this chip on their shoulder. Oh, you didn't recruit me? Okay, I'm going to show you. And that's how they go into the game. Texas didn't recruit me, and I had some unbelievable Texas players. When you go look at Fred Talley and Caleb Miller, Sparky Hamilton, you can go on and on. So many players made a difference. Chris Houston was another one that was from Austin, Texas. He was from Austin, Texas. You can bet how wound up and motivated he was because they didn't offer him. And so that it goes a little deeper now with those guys. When they feel like they got slighted or they got overlooked, now's the time where they feel like I'm fixing to show the coaches on the other sideline what they missed. And so, but when you have that on top of some hungry Arkansas-raised young men, wow, watch out.
Coach, you've been a part of some incredible atmospheres inside of Donald W. Reynolds Razorback Stadium, 99 against Tennessee, 06 against Tennessee. There's been some others mixed in there as well, 06 USC, kind of first half. When you look at tomorrow night, sold-out crowd, expanded stadium, really the first time that it'll be packed out since its expansion because of COVID this past year, how much of an effect are Razorback fans going to have on Hudson Card Thompson and that entire Texas offense tomorrow night?
I always feel like the home field advantage, when it's rocking, when it's right, and like it's going to be Saturday, I always felt like 3 to 7 points was the advantage for us at home. And I say that because when your fans come with this passion that they're going to have, and remember, as you hit on last year, there was none. It was so hard for me just watching games in New York studio without the noise level, without the band, without the cheerleaders and all that excitement. So now when you fast forward to this Saturday night, you have that. I expect the fans to play every play. That'd be my message to them. Hey, don't just come to watch now. You've had a year off. You've had a year to really, store some energy up. So let's come to participate, and let's make it extremely hard. I've seen that stadium make it very, very hard on the opponent, very hard. You can ask Tommy Tuberville. You can ask Nick Saban. You can ask any coach in the SEC that's come to Fayetteville, come to Little Rock, and they'll tell you, very, very difficult. And that's when the fans are at a very high level. They're calling those halls with enthusiasm, with passion. And I expect the fans to play every single play, to be a participant, and to be a difference maker.
So, Coach, you kind of just gave a message to fans. I want to close you down with this. Prior to Arkansas playing number one Alabama, we had you on, and you gave what I thought was a fantastic impromptu, off-the-cuff pregame speech. Let's say you're sitting in front of this team tomorrow night. What is your final message to them before they step foot in Donald W. Reynolds Razorback Stadium?
Yeah. You know, you don't have to say much this week because they realize it's a big game. It's Texas. And so my biggest message would be, hey, these are the best days of your life. And there's going to be a lot of brothers and sisters and mothers and uncles and grandmothers and granddads. They're all eyes are on you. And so what's important is you do your best. You turn it loose. You turn it loose every single play. We can live with whatever happens as long as you're giving Razorback effort. Each play, you know, it's going to come down to 3 or 4 plays, and we don't know which 3 or 4 plays will be the difference. But as long as you have that thing on full throttle, you can be a difference maker. So let's go out there and let's lay on the line. And to me, that's what it's all about, because these are truly the best days of your life. Let's go.
Best days of your life. Coach. Coach, we appreciate your time this morning. I don't think there's anyone that probably has been in that chair that understands the passion and what it means better than you. And you've been gracious with your time this morning. We appreciate it.
Hey, appreciate y'all having me. Thank you.
Hey, Coach, I haven't been in the locker room with you, but I've been out there on that practice field, and I've seen you call them up in a circle. And, you know, I sneak forward, and I want to tell you there's been many and many a time that I wanted to reach and grab one of those helmets and get on that bus and go with you. So, Coach.
I hear you, Clay. I hear you. That's what you miss the most right there.
That's it, baby.
Those relationships and getting everybody ready to go, all pulling in the same direction.
You were the best, I'm telling you.
Well, I appreciate that. Thank you.
Coach, enjoy the weekend.
Thank you. Going to.
Former Razorback coach Houston Nutt with us here on the Morning Rush. Brought to you by Williams Tractor. They're in Fayetteville, Berryville, also Bobcat of Northwest Arkansas, and Rogers. Hey, they got simple, tough, affordable options when it comes to quality bales and a wide range of conditions. The perfect choices for smaller livestock farms, sundowners, and rural lifestylers. Williams Tractor can help you choose from 3 different models by New Holland. Ones that make 4x4 bales and 2s that make 4x5 bales. Plus 0% financing or cash discounts right now. The RF Series Round Balers by New Holland. They're available at Williams Tractor, Fayetteville, Berryville, and Bobcat of Northwest Arkansas.
You can tell the passion hasn't left it.
Nope.
Left him, has it?
Not a bit.
Best
days of your life.
Yeah, he's still got it. Now, I think, Clay, I don't think you've met my father, but Tommy has. My dad is the most clean-cut, follow-the-law individual, and he just sent me and my brother a text of a Texas truck with the Texas Longhorn and the Nike sign, all that jazz. And he said, how much for me to spray paint this truck? He hates Texas too, because he's a Baylor alum, and he feels like that they always get the short end of the stick, or like Arkansas fans similar do. But Texas, just for some reason, not just with Arkansas, with Oklahoma, lots of members of the Big 12, the old Southwest Conference. There is something that that school, that logo, that fan base brings out of fans that I don't know if anyone else in the country does, to be honest. We got an Iowa fan that just walked by. Y'all going to beat Iowa State this weekend? Y'all going to beat Iowa State this weekend? Big time. We got a big conference going on here right beside us, and he saw our ESPN logo, so I guess he's probably not going to be making his way to Ames.
No, he didn't, but he didn't mind the horns down logo.
No,
we got
he liked
on
that.
Location.
And that's an Iowa fan. I don't know what conflicts Iowa has with Texas, but that is just a universally hated logo outside of Austin.
Yeah, Iowa State may have a few, but I don't know about Iowa.
Just tell your dad to key that truck.
Key it. Make it simple, Pops. Just key the truck. Don't even spray
any eggs. Any eggs handy? That might be one thing. Hey, does your business website need an update? If you've forgotten how to edit it, you know how to log in, or you just need to start over, maybe you've started a new business and need a website, see your friends. They're Hog fans, too, at Matchstick Studios and ModularOrange.com. They can get you a quick website going that you will like. Go to ModularOrange.com and see examples of their work. Hey, the fall and winter months are ahead. Those are the busiest times for online traffic, and you don't want to miss out. And they can take care of all the techie stuff you don't want to deal with, and it's only $95 a month. So that'll fit right into your small business budget. Call Jordan at 479-755-3043. That's 755-3043. Or visit ModularOrange.com.
That conversation with Coach Nutt will be in the Bud Light Seltzer Morning Rush podcast. We've been talking a lot of Arkansas, Texas this morning. Clay, we also got to watch a great football game last night. You told me you couldn't turn it off because of how good of a game and how it concluded as we saw Tom Brady's Tampa Bay Buccaneers kick a game-winning field goal against Dak Prescott's Dallas Cowboys. And it was back and forth the first half, and it slowed down a little bit in the second half. But what a great start for the NFL season last
night. Yeah, I had a lot of fun last night. I want to thank Andy Hawkins from Conway, city councilman from Conway. He sent me in 1980, he was the sports director for 24.
I think it was 20. KPOM was their call letters then.
Yeah, Fort Smith, Fayetteville. Uh-huh. And he did an interview with my dad, Orville Henry, the day before the Arkansas-Texas game. That was a Monday game on Labor Day. And the interview was supposed to be just about, that game. And at the end of the 2 or 3 minutes, he asked my dad, he says, just give us the flavor of the Arkansas-Texas series. He started with the 1933 game and covered them all. And as my dad is the only person that can do that.
Yeah.
You know, anyway, Andy saved that tape and presented it to us yesterday via the SoundCloud. I didn't know you could do things from 1980
yeah,
and put it on the SoundCloud. So
the SoundCloud.
Yeah. You know what the SoundCloud is.
Yeah, we're familiar. Just so, called SoundCloud.
Huh?
Just not the SoundCloud, but that's fine. We get your gist.
No, it's the SoundCloud.
I can't wait to hear. You were telling us about this after dinner last night.
So anyway, we sent it to Matt Jones last night, and it's going to be on our podcast today, 13 minutes of the Arkansas-Texas series from Orville Henry.
Oh, can't wait to hear some of that. Hey, Morning Rush brought to you by Liberty National Life Insurance Company for affordable life insurance protection for individuals, families, the self-employed, and small business owners. Call Liberty National Life Insurance at 479-717-2860. That's 717-2860. And tell Jason Everett we say hello.
Yeah, and also don't forget about staying at the Game Day Lodge as well. More of the Morning Rush coming up after this local
it's
break.
It's Beat Texas Week, brought to you by Crane Hyundai of Fayetteville. Visit them at cranehyundaiofayetteville.com or at 1919 West Foxglove Drive today. And our best bank, ready to help you. Equal Housing Lender, member FDIC.
And he could go. The 15, the 10, the 5. Touchdown, Cedric Cobb.
Standard Materials Group has immediate openings for ready-mix drivers in the Northwest Arkansas area. If you have a seat.
You know, the start of the season is just around the corner, and if you're into sports betting, BetOnline is where you should go to win some money today. Whether it's live bets during games or future bets on who you think will win the championship, BetOnline has all the latest odds, news, and information for all your online sports betting needs. Visit the website today or use your mobile device to join and receive a 50% welcome bonus on your first deposit. So before the next big game or before the season starts, head on over to BetOnline and start playing today. That's BetOnline, your online sportsbook experts.
Tommy Kraft here. When it came time for new gates and some fence repairs at my home, the Fence Man was my first call. The Fence Man does it all, from large commercial jobs to small residential repairs. Wood privacy fence, vinyl fence, commercial or residential chain link, even custom wrought iron fencing. 479-782-3936. 18 months, same as cash financing with approved credit, is now available. If it involves fencing, the Fence Man does it. The Fence Man. He ain't afraid of no work. 479-782-3936.
Now that's a dandy white perch. Big old slab.
C'est bon, succulent.
One beautiful crappie.
It's a paper mouth.
Some serious crappie.
Nice speck.
We got crappie.
They might go by different names, but all prefer the same thing. Bobby Garland, America's favorite. White perch, slab, succulent, paper mouth, crappie, speck, crappie baits.
I call it dinner.
Sammy Hagar hammered out this classic hard rock tune, "There's Only One Way to Rock." The Bible hammers out this hard rock truth, "There's only one way to God." And this world can disagree. They don't understand how this must be. And it's not my point of view, it's a fact, and you know that it's true. There's only no way that Jesus and his disciples would willingly die for what they knew to be a lie. I'm Pastor Heath from Woodland. Think about it.
The Game Day Lodge in Branson is the perfect place for corporate retreats, golf trips, and team building activities. You'll find 10 bedrooms with 19 beds for up to 28 guests, 9 bathrooms, 17 TVs, poker table, 2 kitchens, 2 laundry rooms, a fire pit, 2 gas grills, outdoor basketball court, a heated indoor swimming pool nearby, and a 10-minute drive to Silver Dollar City. Not to mention near some of the best golf courses. Just search Game Day Lodge on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, Airbnb, and VRBO.
You know, the start of the season is just around the corner, and if you're into sports betting, Bet Online is where you should go to win some money today. Whether it's live bets during games or future bets on who you think will win the championship, Bet Online has all the latest odds, news, and information for all your online sports betting needs. Visit the website today or use your mobile device to join and receive a 50% welcome bonus on your first deposit. So before the next big game or before the season starts, head on over to Bet Online and start playing today. That's Bet Online, your online sportsbook experts.
Tommy Kraft here. When it came time for new gates and some fence repairs at my home, the Fence Man was my first call. The Fence Man does it all, from large commercial jobs to small residential repairs. Wood privacy fence, vinyl fence, commercial or residential chain link, even custom wrought iron fencing. 479-782-3936. 18 months, same as cash financing with approved credit, is now available. If it involves fencing, the Fence Man does it. The Fence Man. He ain't afraid of no work. 479-782-3936.
Now that's a dandy white perch. Big old slab.
C'est bon, succulent.
One beautiful crappie.
It's a paper mouth.
Some serious crappie.
Nice speck.
We got crappie.
They might go by different names, but all prefer the same thing. Bobby Garland, America's favorite. White perch, slab, succulent, paper mouth, crappie, speck, crappie baits.
I call it dinner.
Sammy Hagar hammered out this classic hard rock tune, "There's Only One Way to Rock." The Bible hammers out this hard rock truth, "There's Only One Way to God." And this world can disagree. They don't understand how this must be. And it's not my point of view, it's a fact, and you know that it's true. There's only no way that Jesus and his disciples would willingly die for what they knew to be a lie. I'm Pastor Heath from Woodland. Think about it.
The Game Day Lodge in Branson is the perfect place for corporate retreats, golf trips, and team-building activities. You'll find 10 bedrooms with 19 beds for up to 28 guests, 9 bathrooms, 17 TVs, poker table, 2 kitchens, 2 laundry rooms, a fire pit, 2 gas grills, outdoor basketball court, a heated indoor swimming pool nearby, and a 10-minute drive to Silver Dollar City. Not to mention near some of the best golf courses. Just search Game Day Lodge on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, Airbnb, and VRBO.
You know, the start of the season is just around the corner, and if you're into sports betting, Bet Online is where you should go to win some money today. Whether it's live bets during games or future bets on who you think will win the championship, Bet Online has all the latest odds, news, and information for all your online sports betting needs. Visit the website today or use your mobile device to join and receive a 50% welcome bonus on your first deposit.
We've got Arkansas, Texas tomorrow night at 6, and we've got 2 more segments of the Morning Rush where you're welcome to hop in as well.
We could use about 10 more to get it all in today. Larry Rath's with us. He's getting ready for a big weekend. Larry, thanks for joining us. I know you got a lot going on before the Hogs and Horns tomorrow night.
Yes, we absolutely do. Listen, there's plenty of time to get in here and get yourself something nicer and newer at Rath Auto Resources. We've got our end of summer clearance going on. And, you know, it's a real deal. We're going to flip the inventory. We've got, a couple of hundred vehicles to move. And, folks, that means you can save some money on a nicer, newer car now at Rath Auto Resources in Fort Smith, Rath Mitsubishi in Springdale. And these are Rath road-ready cars, trucks, SUVs, really a deep selection, and savings up to $4,800 below retail. So it's real and a great time to save. You know, if you're keeping the car you have, you got to take care of it. We need to talk about that Meineke Car Care Center a little bit. You know, everybody's got to take care of their car. And the Meineke Car Care Centers are the best place to do that. They got buy three, get one free on tires right now. They got half off brakes. They've got that Meineke credit card. And folks, if you don't have that in your pocket, you should. It's easy to qualify for. Come in, grab an application, and maybe you can do that online as well. And then you've got that, for those unexpected repairs. It never seems to be convenient when you got to work on your car. Meineke credit card kind of takes the sting out of that. And if you're needing to do anything major on your car right now, when you spend up to $600 or over $600, use your Meineke credit card, you get $100 back. So come on in, ask about that. We'll get you hooked up on that. Let us take care of your car in the Meineke Car Care Center. Better yet, get in here and trade for something nicer and newer this weekend at Rath Auto Resources in Fort Smith, Rath Mitsubishi in Springdale. You can check us out online, rathauto.com.
All right, Rath Auto Resources, he said at Fort Smith and Springdale. Larry, enjoy the game. Have a great weekend. We'll talk to you next week.
Absolutely, guys. Yo, Hogs.
All right. So, Larry Rath with us, Rath Auto Resources. As Ty was saying, we are live in Branson this morning. The folks here have been so kind to include us in on a big event they're having this weekend. And if you're even if you're headed to the game, there's still time Saturday and Sunday to come out and watch the Powerboat Nationals. This is a championship event for them. And Jason Outman is with us. He's the CEO of the Branson Chamber and CVB here. And, hey, thanks for having us in town for such a fun event.
Yeah, no, thank you for having me. I'm glad to be here.
And going to be a fun weekend. I know a lot of our listeners are familiar because they're like me. Their wives make them go down to the landing and spend some time, and you find a great place like Katina Laredo or somewhere to have you a cold one while your wife's doing some shopping. It's such a great area, and this weekend it's going to be filled with powerboats. It's like NASCAR on water here on Tanny Como.
You know, it's an exciting event, and you're right. The landing will fill up. There'll be, thousands of people everywhere watching the races, enjoying all that there is to do, a little shopping, a little eating. And there's nothing like watching those powerboats skip across Lake Tanny Como.
You know, we were talking before we came back about, really how sports-focused Branson has become. A lot of people have a perception of what Branson is, that it's shopping and shows, and there's a lot of great points to that as well. But, you've got not just the Powerboat Nationals. You've got great a travel ball destination right here. Golf courses, unbelievable golf courses that Johnny Morris and the Branson area have developed. It's really becoming a sports destination as well.
Yeah, we're excited about where we're headed. Golf Pass just voted us the number 41 golf destination in the world.
Sounds low to me.
And I agree.
If you've seen these courses, these courses that Johnny Morris has developed are unreal.
There's nothing like the 19th hole at Paynes Valley. So if you're finishing up the 18 holes and you're still tied, and you go to that 19th hole for that tiebreaker. You know, it's beautiful. But, you know, we've got Ballparks of America with the travel clubs, as you mentioned. We just hosted the Cal Ripken World Series at the Ballparks of America, and the Branson team won. So we're excited about that.
One that I don't know if it's a sport or not, but one thing me and my daughter enjoy is zip lining. And there's some zip line. We were looking it up after we'd done it the first one, looking for new places to go, and Branson's got several options on that. So if you like the zip lining. But, and there's one right over here at the landing you can do, too.
Yeah, right across the landing. We've got one that called Vigilante that's 140 feet in the air. Got to admit, I chickened out on it, wasn't able to do it. My wife and my kids were, but I wasn't able to do it, 140 feet in the air.
Could you do that, Ty, 140 feet?
Hey, I can do anything. Not worry about
like
it.
Like your confidence. Like your confidence.
It's never been lacking.
All right, great weekend to be here in Branson. Great, you know, even if you're going to the football game or if you're just watching the game, you can get here and really enjoy everything that's beginning today but going through Sunday as well.
Yeah, you know, and if you miss out this year, come back in 2022 because the Powerboat Nationals Grand Prix will be back, and it's actually the first time they've ever revisited a destination. So we'll have them back in 22, but come this weekend. Beautiful weather, beautiful location. Get a nice ice cold drink and watch some fun.
All right, you're a big college football fan. You're
a
Michigan State man, but who do you like in this Arkansas-Texas game?
You know, I'm trying to learn what both coaches are doing this year. You know, you got the Alabama blood coming over in Texas, mm-hmm. but based on where I live now, I'll say go Hogs.
There you go. Can you say woo pig?
I can try. Woo pig.
There you go. So you're one of us now. So there you go. Jason, thanks for having us.
Thank you, gentlemen. Enjoy the day.
All right, Jason Altman. He is the CEO of the Branson Chamber of Commerce and kind enough to join us here as we near the landing.
So. Yeah, we're getting ready for this Arkansas-Texas game. We're going to be joined back again by Clay Henry coming up. Arkansas in these games is often finds themselves as the underdog, and we'll discuss why they're the underdog and how they can take advantage of that tomorrow night coming up.
All right, Burton Pools and Spas can help you design the backyard of your dreams. Get by Burton Pools and Spas in Springdale and in Fort Smith. Save up to $3,500 right now on Doughboy above ground pools. They're priced to sell right now. That's $3,500 in savings. Burton Pools and Spas in Springdale, just off I-49 at the 412 exit, and in Fort Smith on Zero Street, and always online at burtonpools.com. Burton Pools and Spas is your source for backyard fun.
And it's your final chance on the Morning Rush this week to chime in your opinion. What happens in this football game tomorrow night? We'll let you answer that coming up.
Follow the show on Twitter at HitThatLineAR and on Facebook and Instagram at HitThatLine.
This is former Razorback, wide receiver, and All-American track and field athlete Richard Smith, and you're listening to The Morning Rush.
Finding the places in life that give you joy is what Toyota is all about. Is your idea of fun filled with adventures? Like mountain biking with your good buddies. Woo-hoo! Toyota has SUVs like RAV4 and Highlander, ready to take you wherever that next adventure lies. Or maybe one of our sporty, stylish sedans, like a Camry or Corolla, to get you anywhere in style.
And we're here.
I love the theater.
Try to not fall asleep this time.
What? Me? Or maybe your happy place is in the great outdoors, and Toyota trucks can take you camping, fishing,
got one,
or whatever you love doing. Dependable Tundra and Tacoma are built to get you to the middle of nowhere and back.
Throw another log on there.
That's providing you want to come back. So no matter where you find your joy, Toyota has vehicles ready to take you there. Get $500 customer cash, or qualified lessees can lease a new 2021 Highlander L for only $289 a month for 36 months with $29.99 due at signing. Toyota, let's go places. Visit toyota.com for details. Offers available in select states and 10-4-21.
Tired of wearing contacts, glasses, or bifocals? Volt Vision of Northwest Arkansas has an option for you no matter your age. LASIK or clear lens exchange. Quick 15-minute procedure, easy 24-hour recovery, and freedom from contacts, glasses, and or readers. Bold Vision, that's V-O-L-D Vision. Mention ESPN for $500 off your LASIK or clear lens exchange procedure. Bold Vision, the official eye care provider of the Arkansas Razorbacks.
Wherever work takes you, we've got you. The B.F. Goodrich Trademan Support Program. Get a $70 rewards card after online submission with the purchase of four new B.F. Goodrich passenger or light truck tires. You also get a $60 satisfaction guarantee and 24-hour worksite or roadside assistance. Southern Tire Mart, just off of I-540 at exit 14 in Fort Smith. B.F. Goodrich Tires and best-in-class service. See bfgoodrichtires.com/tradesman for complete details. Offer expires 12/31/2021. Void where prohibited. Looking for a fence company that will provide the personal touch to your fence or gating project? Call Dusty's Fence Company at 479-629-4190. Dusty's Fence Company specializes in custom wood design, vinyl fencing, chain link and ornamental iron projects, and they can even stain your fence to complete your project. Family owned and in business for 20 years, you will deal with the same person from start to finish. That's Dusty's Fence Company, 479-629-4190.
If you think nothing good happens after dark, you've clearly never brought the crew to B-Dubs. Our new half-off late-night food will make you wish you were nocturnal. Every night starting at 9 p.m., get 50% off Ultimate Nachos, Chips and Salsa, plus Crispy Buffalo Chicken Tots or Dirty Dubs Tots. So don't sleep on our late-night food and $3 Tall House beer. Grab the crew and get the Buffalo Wild Wings for late night.
Valid 7-12 through 8-31 at participating locations starting at 9 p.m. till close for dine-in only. 50% off only available on select items. Add-ons cost extra. Excludes other offers. Excludes tax and alcohol. Please drink responsibly.
Have you ever been to River City Bistro for a brunch on the weekends? Every Saturday and Sunday. River City is open at 10 a.m. with a special brunch menu. Eggs and omelets any way you like. Premium bacon, sausage and ham, waffles, eggs benedict, and a great drink menu featuring mimosas, Bloody Marys, and all your brunch favorites. We will see you for brunch every Saturday and Sunday starting at 10 a.m. at River City Bistro, 7320 Rogers Avenue in the Stonewood Village Shopping Center.
September is here, and at Frank Row Furniture, it's time to sell, sell, sell. Everything's on sale. Made in the USA furniture, family-owned, and serviced after the sale. Also, we have in-store, no-credit check financing. I want you to remember one name, Frank Row Furniture, located at 405 Fourth Street in Barling, Arkansas, or check us out on Facebook. Frank Row Furniture, best seats in the house.
Why do I run? Is it because I'm driven? Because I love the challenge? God, no. I do it for the beer. If you're the kind of runner who does it for the beer, this summer you can get one on us with the Michelob Ultra Beer Run. Grab your run buddies and get out there, because this summer there's beer at the finish line. Sign up at ultrabeerrun.com and trade your miles for beer.
Head to toe, it's gotta be Jelco for hard work and the great outdoors.
With quality and price and comfort you like, and savings that you're looking for.
We've got the shoes and boots, steel toes too, outerwear and a whole lot more.
Head to toe, it's gotta be Jelco
for hard work and the great outdoors.
Farm Credit has been a trusted friend for over 100 years. They are ag financing experts. So whether you're a longtime farmer, new to farming, or buying your dream home or land in the country, their experienced staff has a plan to fit your goals, needs, and your bottom line. From farms to land, livestock, equipment, and more, Farm Credit finances it all. Learn more at myaglender.com. Farm Credit is an equal opportunity lender.
ESPN 95.3.
Somebody said we've got SEC bias. Deal with it. They're the best.
In the SEC, it just means more.
I know one thing. The SEC just got a little tougher.
This is your SEC update on the Morning Rush. Brought to you by Atchley Air. Keeping your home comfortable is what they do best. Trust them with your heating and cooling needs. Go to AtchleyAir.com to request service today.
All right, so your SEC update, it's pretty easy. You've got the games this weekend. Now, there's going to be some good games like Arkansas, Texas, and then there's going to be some laughers like Alabama State playing Auburn in Jordan Air Stadium. Now, we just talked with Jason. He's a South Carolina fan. They're taking on East Carolina on the road. Pittsburgh's traveling to Knoxville to take on the Vols. Florida is traveling to South Florida to take on the Bulls. UAB's taking on Georgia. Now, that's an intriguing game because of JT Daniels' absence that's expected for tomorrow. Texas A&M traveling up to Denver to take on Colorado. Mercer, unfortunately, has to go to Tuscaloosa.
Mercer.
NC State traveling to Starkville. Now, that's going to be, an interesting football game. Mississippi State barely edged it out against Louisiana Tech last week. And then Austin Peay, let's go Peay. Traveling to Ole Miss. Did y'all see Lane Kiffin trying to get Katy Perry to come down with corn dogs and watch the Rebels in the Grove? Did you see that?
Yeah, I don't think I'm not a Katy Perry person, so
I could have guessed that.
So I got trivia. This is trivia. This is important. Yeah.
Okay.
So South Carolina is playing at East Carolina. Is that what you said?
Are they not playing at East Carolina?
I thought it was in Columbia, but
okay. I would be really surprised if they were going to East Carolina.
It has East Carolina. Hold on. It has East Carolina as the home team.
Okay. Here's the test.
Kay. That game is in Greenville.
Oh, you blew it. No, okay. Did you know where East Carolina was?
I actually did because I got a job offer in college in Greenville.
Greenville where?
South Carolina or North Carolina.
That's what I knew. You didn't know. So
I knew it was one of them.
East Carolina is in Greenville, North Carolina.
North Carolina. Okay. I was offered three jobs out of college, Denver, Colorado, Nashville, Tennessee, and Greenville took the job, and it ultimately led me here. The best bar in the country, college bar, is in East Carolina. It's called Sup Dogs. You ever been to Sup Dogs, Clay?
I have not, no.
We'll see if you and me can make it over there at some point in time. But
that sounds like a road trip for next summer.
I can't wait.
Hey, can you, just a long trip down 40. Can you go do that and tell me how it is?
How it is? I mean, I'll take pictures. I'll send you videos.
Oh, I think y'all should drive together.
I think we'd have a great
time.
Well,
I want to tell you what. I had a really sinking feeling yesterday when I arrived here at the convention center Hilton here in Branson, which is beautiful. I've got a corner room. It's an unbelievable room.
It's a handicap room,
but
it is
a handicap accessible. But I'm not to that point.
They thought at your age you may need that.
Yeah. So. But when I first got here, they didn't have my name down, and they said we've got two rooms for the ESPN Arkansas guys, and there's three of y'all, right? And I said yeah. And I thought they were going to put me in the same room with Ty.
That would have been added value, as we call it.
The bell captain had my luggage, and I said, just put it back in the truck. Just put it back. Hold on for a little bit, boys. And then it turned out I had the primo room.
You
of
did.
The suite of the three of us.
Ty insisted it be that way.
Age before beauty.
Yes.
I'm just always trying to make sure that
we had an Italian dinner last night that was wonderful. Out of this world. Tommy took us to a place. I was surprised. I ordered the seafood scampi and then made the rest of my order. And Ty says, I'll have what he's having.
Yeah.
Exactly.
I don't know whether you couldn't read Italian. You didn't know what any of those words meant. But I was surprised he did not order a White Claw.
No alcohol for me Sunday through Thursday during the week, unless it's a holiday, unless there's no show the next day. You know.
Yeah,
that.
I think I kind of broke that rule.
Yeah. All right, is that all of our SEC update?
Do you want to talk about something else?
Nope, I'm just making sure before I do the read. So, all right, SEC update brought to you by Atchley Air, proud sponsors of Razorback Athletics. Atchley Air, it's the one you want. Schedule your service call today at AtchleyAir.com.
All right, so we got this Arkansas-Texas game, and we did say we'd open it up. General Ben, you're welcome to jump in here. Got about a minute or two.
A minute.
What's up, man?
20 seconds.
Clay, if you don't mind, I'm 69. How old are you, sir?
I'm older than that.
Okay, well, I'll be 70 in October, so I'll be gaining. Sir?
I'm 67.
Sir?
I am 67.
Okay, well, I got you about 2 years. Because, three years, counting October 19th. So I got you about 2 years and some odd. But anyway, I know you're going to have the same memories I do. Sir?
Sir? Stop it, Clay. I'm going to turn your mic off. Go ahead, Ben.
That's all right. He's getting good stuff in. I imagine the people listeners are liking it, hopefully, with what he's saying. But anyway, I know they are. But anyway, I just wanted to tell y'all, and Clay can confirm it, maybe I've probably already been talking about how much the Texas game used to mean to us in the late 50s and the rest of the 60s, because and I'm just going to confirm what other people have been saying on the show probably during the week, especially as seniors or experienced Razorback fans, I'll say, and that the Texas game meant and decided who was going to go to the Cotton Bowl, because it meant the winner of the Arkansas-Texas game meant who was going to win the Southwest Conference, who was going to host the Cotton Bowl, and who had which team between Arkansas and Texas had a shot at the national championship.
Good stuff, General Ben. Yeah,
that's why this series means so much, Clay, is there's been so many games of consequence starting, like Ben was saying, particularly in the 60s, you know, after Coach Broyles got here in, 58, You know, all those games in the 60s meant so much.
Well, they were top 10 games.
Yeah.
I mean, it's the whole nation was watching a lot of those games. There were three straight, I guess 62, 63, 64, where Texas was number one, all three of those. Arkansas won two of those. Let's see. They won 64, 65, 66. And really kind of sent Texas into a spiral until Darryl found the wishbone, and that was the surge that came.
You know, we were talking to Bill Montgomery earlier this week, and his record in, 68, 69, 70 was 28-5, but the Longhorns were the nemesis when you look at those five, and that's really, I mean, you just can't even grasp how great that record is at 28-5, but still the Longhorns were the with a thorn in the side.
But they were so good.
Yeah.
And they were, I mean, they had everything rolling at that time, Texas did. So I like to talk to Lloyd Phillips, who's passed, but he was so proud that his 3 years they went undefeated against Texas.
It's been much like the relationship in the SEC between, say, Bama and LSU. LSU's had some really good teams that just weren't as good as Alabama's, but they were really good football teams a lot of times. But Bama was just always kind of right there and edged them. But every now and then, LSU will get them, kind of like
2019.
Yeah, kind of like Arkansas and Texas in the 60s.
Texas has got better players 9 times out of 10 in this series, but they haven't won 9 times out of 10.
Yep.
There's been a game or two in that series where Arkansas has now I will say this, the last time they played, I guess, was in the NRG Stadium in the Texas Bowl. Arkansas had better players. I think Texas has done a little better in recruiting of late, but they're not rolling yet. No. They're still trying to figure their way along with Steve Sarkisian, and I think this is a good time for Arkansas to get them. And I think if they play a clean game, I like Arkansas's chances.
You always like to reference that if you get a team, a great team like a Georgia or an Alabama, you want to play them early on in your schedule because they haven't figured it all the way out yet. Well, you're getting that in Texas week two, not to mention new coach and Steve Sarkisian that's still trying to implement his system offensively. And who's the DC from BC or from Boise?
Pete Kwiatkowski.
That's a difficult name to say. So they're trying to implement a lot of stuff very quickly. And I mean, Hudson, let's remember this. We were talking about Jalen and Traylon, all these guys haven't played in a fully packed out Donald W. Hudson Card and Thompson haven't played in an atmosphere like they're going to face tomorrow night. You don't know. What's the old Mike Tyson quote? Everyone's got a plan until they get hit in the mouth.
Mm-hmm.
The best thing that could happen for Arkansas tomorrow night is an early interception, early fumble, and you see Card and that offense frantic on the sideline. Because, again, the rowdiness that you heard Coach Nutt talk about, it's going to be there, not just in first quarter,
well,
but all night.
See, I think Arkansas shook Dwayne Mathis in the first half of that game last
year. Yeah, 100%.
And they changed quarterbacks in the second half and kind of settled things down. But they'll have their chances, and there'll be some adversity, and we'll see how Texas handles it.
If you win the coin toss, you want the ball first or go on defense first?
Yeah, I always in big games, I kick.
I'm with Clay.
Take the ball in the second half.
Because I like to have, if you can work it out, if it works out, you get the end of the half possession, and then you get it first, you can really change momentum if you need to.
Be honest and be dead honest about it. Do you really have confidence that Arkansas won't go 3-and-out in their first drive?
Well,
no, I've got more confidence in the defense.
Yeah, no, that's the flip side, is that you want to establish defense in the kicking game and play the game that way.
Yeah.
And I think you can. And I just look at this. You got two number ones out there. You got KJ Jefferson, you got Jalen Catalon. Which one of those number ones you want to put on the field first? I think it's Jalen Catalon.
Yeah. Hey, if you're going to do some pond or creek fishing this weekend, take along the Rebel Creek Hopper. You can twitch it, pop it, walk it, swim it. It's the ultralight fishing lure that looks and acts like a real grasshopper. The Creek Hopper works great in tandem with a light spinning rod reel. Put that 4 or 6 pound fishing line you got in your tackle box on, and you're going to catch
no
some fish.
No burnt orange.
Nope.
Lures.
Nope.
None.
I've got you some over here in the bag, though, from Bruce.
No,
I brought to you.
Don't give me those burnt orange ones.
Find them at Walmart, Bass Pro Shops, Academy, LureNet.com, and tackle shops everywhere. That's the Rebel Creek Hopper.
I think those burnt orange
blow them up
rails would find their ways into the crisp fire like that table did on Tuesday at Frank Rowe Furniture. Just a reminder for everyone listening, we're loaded up this weekend with content. Not only can you listen to Halftime live at, where are they at, the Century Bank?
They are at Century Bank of the Ozarks in Mountain Home.
And then Ruskin and Zach will be at the Stadium Shop in Northwest Arkansas and Fable today on Razorback. Not to mention, we'll have Fantasy Football Sunday coming out on the Hit That Line podcast network later today. We'll have Arkansas Game Day starting at 12 at Randall Ford.
Who's in the office?
Right now?
Maddie T.
Come on, Maddie T.
Howdy.
Hold it down.
He's holding it down. He's holding it down for us.
He's the MVP today.
The head honcho. Yeah. And then we'll have Hog Reaction following the conclusion of the Texas-Arkansas game, and then huddle up with John David White and myself. We'll come out at some point on Sunday. So we've got a lot of content for you. Make sure you're following us on hitthatline.com for all your updates. Andy's been doing a great job getting everything updated. SEC Nation has already set up their stuff. Paul Feinbaum's going to be out on the Lot 44 later today. Marty and Smith tomorrow. SEC Nation tomorrow. I mean, it is just going to be a rowdy atmosphere inside of Donald W.
Well, let's hope at about 9:30 Saturday night it's still rowdy because the Hogs have won or are right there in the game. And hopefully by about 10:30 Dixon's rowdy because it's a victory party. That's what I'm
hoping. That can happen. I believe it can.
Well, speaking of Dixon, my brother's sending me videos of them taking – shots with Clay Travis last night inside Dixon Street, and I was like, geez Louise.
That's the right Clay. Yeah. As long as I'm not there.
You were just sitting watching me and Clay drink at the bar last night.
I didn't even have water. I was just sitting there like a bump on a log. Yep. So, everyone, it's been a great Friday, Football Friday edition of the Morning Run. Again, I really appreciate Explored Branson having us out here. Powerboat Nationals this weekend, Grand Prix, really excited about that. For Clay, Tommy, and all our Morning Rush listeners, I'm Ty Richardson. Halftime coming up at 11.